I'm Michael Jones, and you're watching Off Topic. If you'd like to see it live every Friday at 12 p.m. Central, click this link right here to sign up to be a first member at roosterteeth.com. You get access to stuff like this amazing podcast, shows like Theater Mode, all our sweet documentaries. You name it, you'll get it. So sign up today. And maybe I won't murder Gavin for what he does in the first 30 seconds of this episode.
Sup?
Yo!
I was saying hello to you, Michael, there.
I said yo.
Oh, yeah.
And then Jeremy just yelled sup in the middle of
our
interaction.
I intruded.
It's a weird Jeremy, version of, like, Tourette's. That I
sup.
Just sit there and yell.
Sup.
I
sup.
Just go, like, you know, I'll be sitting there playing games.
Sup.
Like, hey!
He's not talking to me. Sup. Hey.
Hey, Ryan. How
hey,
you
good.
Doing,
there
man?
We go.
When
I just
someone
you
says,
to have something because they were doing this.
When someone says sup to you, is a valid response sup?
Yeah. Can
yeah.
be.
You can double sup.
It's yeah. not. It's not.
I feel like a lot of time someone's like, sup. And I'd be like, hey, sup. I'd be like, I was asking you. It's like, oh, I'm not actually asking you what's up. I'm saying hello.
Hey, how you doing?
The
you
classic
a good day?
Answer to sup is not much. Sup, not much. You?
That needs a shorter thing.
Or just like
sup is.
At least that's what
that's
it used to be
up.
In like
what's not
I am
much.
Days.
All right, you try it. Say sup.
Hey, sup.
Nothing.
All right.
That needs to be shorter. No, nothing's okay, but yeah, not much needs like a.
We go
I'll
the
do
ceiling,
like
none.
I'll do also
away.
Gavin sup me.
Sup.
Just chilling.
You know?
That's
a real
yeah.
conversation killer.
If
yeah.
you were skydiving.
But I'm saying you want to kill the conversation.
Yeah,
I wouldn't believe you. Oh, well,
like
that's
a wet blanket.
All right.
Yeah, well, are you skydiving? Going,
hey, welcome to Off Topic episode number 48. I almost punched my water over right at the beginning, but
that
I didn't.
Awesome.
This episode is sponsored by Movement Watches and Battlefield 1. I don't have a gun with me, but I'd fire it if I did. Da 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 da. Fun watch, fun game.
That's that.
Oh, so we
Ryan
got,
has been trying to punch through this
he just,
all morning.
As soon as we sat down,
I
he just started
think,
punching it.
I don't think a human can punch through a fresh
pumpkin. I think you could.
That's
I
just
so
don't
hard.
Want him to. It's
I want
go
him to.
Everywhere.
All right, how about this?
Wait,
10
it's empty,
seconds.
Right?
Okay. No,
it's
no.
Not, it's mostly empty.
You come in from this angle.
Pumpkin
I'll hold
spice
it's going to be sticky
empty.
The whole episode.
Hold on, let me move my coffee.
It feels like this is going to hurt.
It will hurt.
It will hurt.
All right,
Ryan is now going to punch a pumpkin that I handcrafted yesterday.
Wait.
Well, I carved it into a jack-o'-lantern. I didn't handcraft
using
a pumpkin.
Using a giant knife,
it's
like
a giant
ritual knife.
Knife. Yeah.
Up! No, I bought that in Germany. You asshole. It's all your fucking fault.
The holder! Where did the holder go?
What did I just say? You stupid asshole! We're 5 fucking
save
seconds in and now there's broken glass, you fuck! Oh, and my phone! I'm gonna fucking beat you to death! I'm gonna beat you to death in a goddamn Aquabats costume! You stupid fuck!
Paper towels, please!
You fucking moron! You fucking moron! You left your coffee right in front of me! You dipshit!
It's been an accident!
What a dipshit! You think it's fucking waterproof because it doesn't have the headphone jack anymore?
Oh, wait, look.
God!
Oh,
damn
you
summoned
it.
I broke it.
You did. In other news,
in other
Ryan
news,
cracked
pumpkin
the pumpkin.
Cracked.
Huh. Where are the papers?
You fucking cunt.
That is...
What?
That's the moment for an animal right there. I just want...
So for audio listeners,
Michael, I would like to
all
apologize.
Hell just right, fucking
yeah,
broke
okay.
loose directly
like
at me
to you
so,
for what just happened there.
Here's yeah for the audio listeners.
Explain it while I rinse my fucking phone off.
All right, Gavin,
where are you going, Gavin?
Had two hands on a pumpkin, holding it for Ryan. Ryan loaded up. Took a swing at the pumpkin, did actually crack it right there, and
delivered
that,
a powerful
and a little
strike.
Bit there,
it's
too.
It's soft.
It was a powerful strike.
Yeah.
Gavin, in a similar fashion to saying he was going to hold the monitor in the desk video.
I don't know why we trusted him after that.
Just put hands on it. It's we just realized it's the exact same thing
you
do with your monitor in the desk video. You
I,
went,
I'm just, I'm
I'll
not,
hold it, and then you do this.
I've not got a good grip.
And he punched it. The whole thing rolled. Knocked over Michael's cup, Gavin's
no,
coffee.
Gavin's coffee.
Thus hitting Michael's glass of water, knocking down. A chain reaction. Shattered on the floor. There is now a mixture of coffee and water, which can only be described as awful,
and
on the ground.
And the glass.
Michael was covered in coffee,
and
bathing
glass.
In the center of the coffee was his phone. So
that there. Also happened, yes.
Yeah. So, welcome to Off Topic. That was Michael Jones. I'm Jeremy Dooley.
Is that the fastest
Gavin.
We have ever destroyed
yes.
a podcast? Ryan.
Yeah, absolutely, yes.
So
unequivocally.
I'm going to have to review the footage to see what went wrong. But I blocked it one way.
Yeah.
But then it just went the other way.
I mean, I
remember
think
earlier
I
when Ryan and I were
way.
Talking about whether we could punch either side of it?
Oh,
yeah. And
a
we
shot
said
glass.
What could happen is we graze it and then it spins the other
yeah.
way. Exactly what happened.
The pumpkins
there.
Are very, they're slippery beasts.
There's literally
that
just like a pile of broken glass
that
right on the floor.
Like one of the worst things, dude. Man.
It's got the. Did it get you too?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it blasted all over me.
Good thing you had that costume on.
It's, sure.
You
okay.
fucking asshole. Just unrolled like half a roll of paper towels onto it.
I also appreciate how somehow all of this blew up on Gavin.
Well, he didn't hold
it. Same way the desk thing went. He shouldn't.
He's an instigator.
Yeah,
he wants
instigator.
It. He needs it.
I didn't want
happen.
This. I wanted a pumpkin.
You wanted it and you got it.
I wanted Ryan's fist in a pumpkin is what I wanted.
You
got exactly
got
what realistically
I never
was
asked
going
for
to
this.
Happen in the real world.
It's glass. Oh.
Well, you covered glass with a paper towel.
I'm
now
just
a
broom.
Soaking it.
Who's got
I'm
a broom?
Soaking up the liquid so we can then broom the glass.
I just want to sweep
a broom
it so
and
I can
a dustpan.
Put my
go.
Chair back.
That's a broom.
That's a broom. That'll do it. Thank you.
All I'm right. not going to move. I mean, you can all keep right, the
well,
camera right there.
Okay.
This is all going to happen. They're going to sweep it up. They're going to mop up the water. I'm going to be sitting right here at this table. I have the least amount to do with this.
You don't have to go under there. The real victim here is, though, the glass.
I know. I
yeah.
love that glass.
Dude, I'll
like
get a
nice
jet
glass.
Yeah, the glass is gone.
Well, we're just going to have to go to... Move the...
We have to go back to Castle now. I have to go to Kenichi next year.
Anyone in Germany, please.
Well, Castle. Specifically, you go to the gift shop in Castle, Germany. It's where they sell...
There's one gift shop in the whole town?
Well, it's where they sold the dick statue of Hercules. I bought a little dick there. Bought a glass, too. So, you know, if you're in the neighborhood... Sure. Well, I mean,
we
that's
just bung it in like that.
That's pretty good, man. Hell of a start. Hell of a podcast.
You think that's gonna rip, dude? Hefty, hefty, hefty.
Shout out to Movement Watches and Battlefield 1 for sponsoring this.
Watch out! There's still glass in there.
Ow. All
right. A little bit further back. Keep behind.
We'll sell more sponsors. Eventually.
What happened?
There we go.
It was so fast. I think my phone's all
like,
right.
You say what happened, but I really don't know how that happened.
Well,
how did it go that way?
We'll review the footage.
I'm sure it's going to somehow, I rolled my fist or something. I didn't get a good strike.
Gavin thought he could hold something you were punching.
Shout out to the iPhone 7.
Well, I didn't even give it
waterproof
full
casing.
Of course.
That wasn't full beans?
No.
I mean, thank God they got rid of the
fist.
Jack.
If the headphone jack was there, it would have been game over.
If that headphone jack was
still
in, the phone would have exploded.
That your phone was soaking in it. It wasn't until Ryan yelled,
I was like,
get
what?
The phone,
I didn't
that
even
I
see
realized.
It, I honestly
it
didn't
was
see
buried.
It.
And I had a moment where I went, oh, fuck, that's my phone. And then when I picked it up out of the warm coffee, it's like, oh,
it was
not
disgusting
mine.
With it.
Ow!
Yep, there's the glass.
Yeah, a little bit of glass there.
right. Also, I'm going to be opening up... the hashtag, which is, I think, hashtag...
Topic AH. So if you have anything to say, any sponsors out there, you know, firsties watching live, any comments or concerns, go ahead and tweet it at Off Topic AH.
All right, you want to try again?
Jeremy will be checking it out.
Not unless there's nothing on the table.
Well, let's get more stuff piled behind the pumpkin again.
That's what I was doing when that was happening.
Hey, I mean, you still want your coffee? It's still there.
Yeah.
You still got some dregs
got a
left.
Sip in there. I'm sure there's
cool,
sharks.
So I'll just put this back on the set where I got it.
Okay, so.
That was probably the worst outcome possible. I mean, aside
really
from the table exploding
yeah.
into shrapnel, that I couldn't have gone any worse.
The only
and
other
I
thing
tried
that,
to move everything over there.
You did. The only other thing that could have gone wrong was that I would have some kind of heart attack for exercising at that same moment.
Well, anyways. There's the pumpkin. So we have a lot of jack-o'-lanterns on the set today, as you probably see.
God,
these were carved.
Jackasses too.
These were carved yesterday. Yeah, there's mine. These were carved yesterday during a live stream that we did, and with the weaponry. This was carved using a ritual knife by
Michael.
You gotta
pull real hard, Gavin.
This is our logo.
Use them muscles.
Oh, this is the one that Andy did.
Andy
did
this
one. Great notch on top.
Also with the ritual knife.
It's,
I just watched Gavin rip the tap off.
I just need to not be here today. I need to go home and lie down. You said pull it hard.
Because you do have to pull it hard. I pull it hard every week. I've never snapped it off before.
It's rock solid. Someone's, like, done something with it. I need to lie down.
Jeremy's got the beer. He's got
it's just the end of the week.
There you go. It works.
Fucking
it's rock solid.
Yeah,
it's rock solid.
You got quite a head on that one.
Thanks, Jeremy.
It didn't
You're
go
a
fast.
Monster. It's meant to be screwed in. How did it pull off?
You're a monster and an animal. How do you do these things?
I didn't want any of this.
You know what?
Absolutely.
This
you
is. How did we not expect this after the morning we had, though? Right?
Yeah, this morning was a bunch of that too.
What with
and
the
yesterday.
Tech problems?
Well, yeah, our audio recording computer just completely failed to turn on today.
We
yeah,
we
were like,
in.
We're
it
coming
shit,
at it.
So
10,
it shit the bed last night.
Shoot a video. We got to get it shot before this podcast.
Yeah.
And well, turn on.
The screen was off and the fans were on full blast.
Oh,
so
yeah.
It overheated and it was just going. But there was nothing on the
it
screen.
It was the computer equivalent of.
And then it went into a constant reboot loop.
Oh, they were coffee soaked, yeah.
So what do? We unplugged all of Jack's stuff and made that the recording computer.
Yep.
Yep.
He'll be real happy when he gets back.
Well, oh well.
Well, we're going to have to replace it.
He should have been here to defend
it anyway.
Huh? Yeah, he should have been here, that's right.
Exactly.
Should
have
been
is
in
he?
London.
Where
like
is he?
Like Gavin was supposed to be.
Where's Jack now? Oh, he's in London. What?
We did a swappy-do.
Yeah,
a
swap.
Yeah, you didn't really swap shit.
Well, I mean, I was going to be there and now he's there. Swap.
Yeah, a swap's like, hey, Jack, want to go in my place? And you're like, yeah, you not going, and then, oh my god, who else can go? Isn't really a swap.
Yeah.
That's like scrambling to get somebody to go.
There did seem to be an air of desperation to the email that followed that up, yeah.
Oh, there was. Yeah. And it was just Jack and myself in the office when that email came in. And I looked at Jack and went, wow, look at that thing. You wanna
look at that thing.
I was like, you want to go to London? He went, no. And then I guess apparently he went home and Katie's like, go to London.
Yeah, Katie's like, go. Wow. And Jack's like, okay.
All right. I was like, no one's going to be able to go to this. Like, I couldn't go because I agreed to do stuff with, like, Blaine, like, record stuff. I know you already said no. Michael.
Well, he had shit come up. To go. It's, you know.
You
he
had
was,
stuff
he was going.
I was going.
Basically.
And then, all of my shoot got pushed by, like, 10 days. So it's like. Backed up all of my deadlines into that trip.
Ah,
so
he that. Said
so
no.
He couldn't.
And then, so you,
and here's the thing. I might have gone because Lindsay actually went. She went for Ruby with like the other Ruby girls. But because Gavin couldn't go and his shoot got pushed, that means he's here. So it's like the amount of time we're here to film, it makes no sense for me to go if Gavin's here.
And there's
we're
no
talking
way
about
no
how
line.
Nobody's in the fucking office.
I got kids.
So
right,
that's
right,
why I didn't
kids.
Go.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I would have went. I've still never been to England. I really want to go.
Hey, we'll go.
Yeah? Okay. I'll probably go to England for your funeral. That's when I'll go. It'll be the first time I'm there. After I kill you.
Do you think that'll be there, or they'll just bury him between his two houses here?
I think they have to ship my corpse back, don't they?
I mean, who's they?
Why would they have to do
Nobody
that?
Nobody has to do anything.
Just in a box.
They call your family, and you're like...
you want it?
Yeah,
nah.
Basically, yeah.
Your dad answers the phone, sup.
Sup. Sup with you.
Not much. All right, see ya.
Isn't there some statistic like 1 in 10 planes that you fly international, there's a corpse in the
I'm
board,
sure.
Right?
Are you serious?
How do they get them back there?
Mule?
Sure. Across the ocean. Mule
maybe,
swim.
Maybe
well.
On the freight. Maybe like on the FedEx planes, there's more corpses.
Maybe
there's,
like, I don't
a
know. Big
I just put them in a boat. I mean, it'll take a long time. I just stick them in some salt or something. I'll preserve them.
There you go. Sure. Desiccate.
Dump them in the ocean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Make shark food.
Let's
just have like a long cable and just drag it behind the plane.
I mean, or you just,
hydroplaning.
Yeah.
Probably also if you're getting cremated, they like incinerate your ass here and then ship you back, right? Like a
I mean,
box.
I'm pretty sure the ashes aren't really easier. That person anyway.
No, it's
they just do like a whatever. Batch and it's like, here's some of whatever that he was in there.
Some of him is in there.
You can pay extra to watch. Like make sure.
Watch them.
Like,
burn?
Get the body so you get the right ashes back.
Oh.
They make you pay extra for that?
You can do extra for that.
Huh.
I made that up. I'm,
I mean, that's plausible.
I mean, it does seem plausible. It seems certainly like something someone could do.
I feel like you could just make a crematorium at home anyway. Like, maybe just make a big crucible.
Yeah, a couple rocks and some wood. Crematorium.
Concrete, need like a blowhole. You know.
A blowhole?
Here's the thing. This
to get the air hot in there.
You know what you would end up with after that? Is a very charred and disgusting corpse.
Yeah, you would.
Right, it needs to get super hot.
Hmm. How hot do you need to get?
To ash a bone?
Yeah. Immolation of a human bone? That's a good question.
That's some Gears of War stuff right there.
Dude, have you finished Gears 4?
I haven't. I'm gonna play it tonight.
I made the mistake of starting it with Dan when he was here. He left, and now.
Right. I'm playing it with Andy. I've just like been exhausted every day I get home because we've been late. Like yesterday, we did the late stream, so we were here. I got home. I'm like, dude, playing Gears tonight. I planned that in the morning. We're like, oh, dude, we're still playing. I got home. I started watching South Park at like 9 o'clock. 9:30 rolls around. I'm like, oh, you want to play Gears? He's like, I could watch this episode. We put on one more. 10 minutes in the episode, I look at him. I'm like, remember Gears? And I just start laughing. I'm like, tomorrow we'll play. Hot.
You want anybody want to take a stab?
Tyler. 2100 degrees Fahrenheit.
We've got 2100 degrees Fahrenheit. Anybody else?
I'm gonna go 3500.
Wow. 3500.
Every unit of that was undecided until it was coming up.
Yeah, 10,000.
Now, they don't list
volcano
Fahrenheit or a small centigrade, volcano. But I assume it's Fahrenheit. Cremating at the optimum temperature, 1,400 to 1,800 degrees.
Ooh.
Gavin was the closest.
But he did go over, so like, Bob Barker would have his
answer. An average takes 2 to 2.5 hours.
Jesus.
To cook them up just right.
1,400? That's just like triple pizza.
Look, take much.
Yeah, that is triple pizza.
Wow, so like three times the heat of a pizza.
That's like double pizza. Real hot. Mods is like 700 or something. They have like, they super cook it in like 5 minutes
or
something.
That's great.
It's still really hot.
Can you deep fry a pizza?
No, it is.
Yeah, why not?
Sure, you can deep fry everything.
Yeah. I wonder why no one's selling deep fried pizzas.
My chair is
probably
sticky now.
Horrible.
The rungs on my chair are sticky.
Wait, do you batter it first, do you think?
Yeah, you gotta batter everything for deep fried.
Do you?
I mean, do you batter the dough, though? It seems like that wouldn't work.
Sure.
The
sure
dough needs to rise.
This is America. You can batter dough.
I think you'd have to cook the dough first.
Make it rise.
And
drop
then
it
batter and fry.
Oh, I was thinking just a whole pizza, done, ready to go into a box, but instead it goes in batter.
You think you could punch through this, Pumpkin?
I think I've really shown it what for once. It's real squishy.
Yeah.
You actually did put a slit in it.
Look at this.
I can't believe
it's cracked
like
all the way around
minutes
here.
Into this.
Yeah.
And
I really
it's soft.
Didn't want that to happen.
It's like a
baby's head. I
wanted
that to
head.
Be just a simple, nice opening bit.
I know, right?
Oh, it was an opening bit, all right.
It was like an 8-minute bit.
That was a fucking showstopper if I've ever seen one in the history of this company.
What if, for the release of this, we cut it right as Ryan hits it, and then we're just all back in our seats, and it's like, oh, what happened?
No, we'll leave it in.
Well, we don't even need a post show. We just cut that bit out, and that's the post show.
No, the world needs to see what happened. That's going out. Okay?
I just hate being the cause of destruction. And
it's always you.
I know, I don't
you
like
hate
that.
It. You instigate it all. You come up with everything. You're the mastermind. And you're like, I just don't like it. I like doing it, but
Gavin, I'm sorry I contributed to you being the instigator.
It's just another on the... Was this the clip?
Is it Jeremy's got
are
it
we
already?
Watching, like...
This is what happened.
When will then
oh, Jeremy,
be now?
I'm seeing what happened. You guys can buy it. There it is.
Oh, we've got it. All right, let's.
It's just a straight shot too. I didn't even like.
It bounces right.
It
bounces right off Gavin's hands. Play that beginning part again if you can.
Let's go to back and to the left.
Yep. You're gonna have to.
All right,
ah, that's awesome.
That was a cool shot.
It's like you being mad at me 10 times.
It looks even better in the Aquabats outfit.
Okay, here we go. Oh, there it was.
It just rolls off of Gavin's hands.
It was just a snap punch. I didn't even drive it.
I know. It's like a human being could have just held it.
I think you punched it the wrong way.
I looked perfectly like a fine punch to me.
I
think that was the problem.
I'm still sorry, Michael. I'm sorry for your glass. Sorry.
You know, I am too. But it doesn't mean anything for me.
No.
No.
Wow. You look at me and you just think, I want to kill you.
I'm glad you know it at least.
I know.
How worthless
you
it is.
You know I'm sorry and I know you don't give a rat's.
Worthless. God damn.
But, Michael, we have done something good this week.
Exotic.
What have we done?
We put out every episode of Outlast.
We did.
Congratulations.
Yeah, and actually, for firsties who are watching now, Whistleblower starts tomorrow.
Oh,
yeah. By starts, I mean it's only two parts.
Yeah.
They're long parts.
Yeah.
What's, they're like an hour and 10 minutes each.
We routed them out.
Yeah, yeah. We wanted to beat it in like, we wanted to beat it in one go, but we couldn't because you had to do the podcast, so we had to do two cuts, but... It should be two parts.
It's actually quite nice because there's only two of us in that whole series is that if ever we were both free for about an hour, we would just cram in there and do one.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if someone's on at lunch, get in there immediately. It's great. Even in the middle of another shoot, we did Whistleblower.
Yeah, we finished it. That was satisfying because then also I didn't have to come in early the next day.
Turns out,
this is funny.
A lot of the comments
So before...
Oh, yeah.
What happened?
So we started shooting Outlast... And in the middle of Outlast, I don't even think we finished it. We didn't. We were like four or five parts in. Then we played the Outlast 2 demo. But that came out first. The demo came out first, then all the parts that are rolling out. And then after we played the demo, we finished the main game of Outlast. That's why, like, if you watch it, we start talking about the Outlast 2 demo in, like, part 6, because we had just played it.
Mm-hmm.
And in the Outlast 2 demo, that came out, like, right after we shot it.
What happened?
Don't worry about it!
You just banged into everything over there.
Like, every comment was that we were wearing our headphones backwards.
Yeah, and I immediately
what, really?
Thought, because I thought they were referring to our reaction, like, if we would look a certain way, and I was like, idiot, the webcam's flipped, because, you know, we're looking at the screen, so of course, right is left. And then, later comments were like, yeah, they're still wearing their headphones backwards. And I was calling out stuff in the game, like, oh, that's on the right.
Right.
But when you listen to it back, all of that sound is on the left. So I was like... Well, I know I'm not wearing my headphones backwards. The wire comes down the left side.
Mm-hmm.
And every time I put them on, I look at the left and I put them on.
Right.
And so are you.
Right.
How would we both be wearing our headphones?
So, and the best part about that is, we didn't notice it in the demo. People, like, all the comments were like, you're wearing your headphones backwards. No, we're not wearing headphones backwards. Then, Outlast started coming out. And by the time part one came out, we'd shot the whole thing. Fucking all the comments. Like, you're wearing your headphones backwards. I'm like, no, we're not.
Yeah.
We shot Whistleblower. Open up Whistleblower by telling the audience, shut the fuck up, we're not wearing them backwards. We're like, what are you talking about? Gavin goes and watches some of the Outlasts. He's like, yeah, it's backwards.
Yeah, I was like, oh, they're right. Everyone's right. And then I was like,
how?
Is Neil screwing with us somehow?
The editor, right? We're like, is it
Gavin always goes straight to the editor.
Yeah, I was like, what?
As a cause of stuff.
I was like, the editor knows. Because the editor has had to watch all of it. So,
right.
Like, does he know it was backwards? Or is he making it backwards to screw with us?
Right.
Nope, that was fine. He was just making it, putting them out. It turns out, whoever set up that room, the feedback that we can hear each other is flipped.
So
but it's not flipped.
So the recording is fine. So the recording looks fine, but the playback in our headphones is backwards.
Right, but on the thing where there's four plugs,
mm-hmm.
sets of two. There's red and white and red and white. So Trevor and I are looking at them. It's like, well, red's in red, white's in white. Reds and red, whites and white. Where is this wrong? So we didn't actually bother tracing it all the way back down to the next plug. So we just took red and white out, put red in white and white in red, and now it's good. And that's our fix for it.
Oops.
So now, having played every single Outlast
literally
possible,
all
our audio's fixed.
All parts.
There it is.
There won't be a recording.
And this, and
where
this
that's the case.
Also the kicker there is this must have been the case for everything we've ever shot in there. Like the last
two
months of Play Pals, it's just never been that evident
Five
except
nights.
Until Outlast
Five
where it's
nights.
Like super
Ugh.
Directional and you're looking at people.
How does it even go through an RCA plug still? All right.
No,
yeah, whatever.
So,
we don't set stuff
know.
Up. We
Whoops.
Just sit down and play it.
I don't
but
know how to set up that
I'd,
room.
I'd like just
it was,
to stress.
It was correct on the desk and
yeah.
correct on our ears. It's incorrect somewhere else and we just haven't troubleshot that far. But now it's fixed.
But the point is we weren't wearing them wrong.
No.
Yeah. Michael said after he discovered this, he looked at me and went, I'm going to bring this up on the podcast.
Yeah,
so I don't want people thinking I got it
wrong. We look like idiots.
Yeah, we look
and
like
we
idiots.
We were confused because we know we were right, so we were calling them idiots. They weren't idiots. We're idiots, but we didn't know it.
Yeah.
And we're not really idiots.
Well, I mean, it sounds like the idiot is whoever set it up.
Exactly.
Oh,
which wasn't us.
There's the Outlast.
Which
there's wasn't us. Right now.
Here's an Outlast where, you know, we'll look in a wrong direction, I'm sure. But check it out.
Fun game.
Fun
it
game.
A turn towards the end.
It does.
It's a completely like a different game almost.
Yeah.
In
fucking
the look of it.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
We have been trying to do like a terror month kind of thing. Horror.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to say horror, but I hate saying that word.
Horror?
It just sounds like I'm saying
it's hard to say it right.
Horror.
Horror.
So he more adds an A.
That's horror. I think it's technically how you're supposed to say it.
Instead of horror.
Yes. Horror.
Yeah. Horror.
Right. Anyways, we're going to do a lot of scary games. So all the Outlast games
Will
come out.
Do you say horrifying?
That's horrifying.
That's horrifying.
He says horror.
Yeah. I think it's like horrifying.
Horrifying, yeah.
He's fucking horrifying. Dude, it's fucking horrifying. Yeah, I don't know. Whatever.
I'd like to see if that's
how that's you pronounce it. No, in Boston, that's not how they would say it. That's just how I say it. In Boston, they would say horrifying, probably, right?
Yeah, that sounds about
fucking
right.
Fucking horrifying. Like, you see that?
Why didn't you talk
I'm
more
full
about
of
that?
Fucking terror. So anyways, we released a lot of scary games this month, and the one that came out today, if you're a first member and watching this live... video came out today for you in public on Saturday. It's that Emily Wants to Play a Game. They did a PlayPals in it already where there was puppets jumping at you.
It was
and
like
shit.
Dolls, yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't think we figured out how to play it
no.
at any point in
you
that
did
play.
It. We didn't. Fuck
we died a bunch of times and then we stopped playing the game. That's what we did.
Yeah, and they made that game in the Vive, in VR. So that video came out.
Maybe the worst port to VR ever.
That was one of the scariest.
10 times scarier.
Yeah, it's pretty horrible.
I mean, I would say it's 100 times scarier. As in, like, real, actual, like, terror.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a game. It's a screen. You look at it.
Locked in the room.
When you're wearing the thing, it's the first time ever in VR where my heart was like, oh my god. Oh my god. And when the thing flies at you, because when you die, it's just a jump scare. I mean, it's the equivalent of you sitting there and something, like, come fucking hurling at your face. It's horrifying.
You went first. Ryan went second. That just left. Were you there?
I was there.
Yeah, Lil J was there. He didn't play.
You didn't play. So that left.
He's
the
very
three.
Familiar with the
game.
He was the one giving us all the rules.
I knew how to play.
So you weren't in the running, but Jack and I were left, and I was like, Jack, you're up. He's like, I'm not doing it. I don't care what anyone says.
Not even say that.
It wasn't at
refused.
The end. I went first. We decided early on, like, Gavin should definitely play this, but let's not get him to go first, because it'll be scarier to see how fucking scary it is for us, and then he goes. I don't want him to go in not knowing, because then it'll be over before he knows.
You want my pizza
so,
bill.
Exactly. So since I went round one, I mean, it's a pretty short video. It's like 30 minutes or so. But since I started, you were like, I'm not playing.
Yeah.
I'm not playing.
You got
the
jumped.
Whole video, you and Jack are arguing about not playing.
You got jumped and fell on the ground. I was like, nope. And Jack's like, absolutely not. And I was like, I don't want to do it.
So,
I knew full well I was going to get in there. I just really didn't want to.
It's a 25-minute video of someone playing and you and Jack saying you're not going to do it for the whole time.
And Jack was 100% serious. He's like, nothing is going to make
me put on really put his foot down.
Jack,
like,
Jack put his foot down hard. This is great. He says in the video, this is near the end, when it's coming to the third round, I'm like, I just kept going, one of you is playing it. One of you is playing this fucking game. It's going to happen. And Jack goes, I don't care. I don't give a shit. I don't care what the comments say. Call me a bitch. Call me a pussy. I don't care. I'm not doing it. I'm not going to play. It's not happening. I'm not going to do it.
He's like,
no.
I got bad heart.
He was like, absolutely not. Never. Never.
Yeah, he was like, I'm too old. It's going to stop my heart or something.
It was impressive. I was actually impressed at his resolve. It was like, never in 100 million years am I ever going to play this game ever. No.
I didn't realize he was that opposed to scary games.
And then it hard cuts to me, just stood there with
Yeah, the kicker is, when I started, like, we were still futzing with, like, the headphones, and I didn't have sound. So by the time I got the sound working, I didn't realize the game had started, because the monsters don't come out immediately when you walk in. You have to wait for it to become midnight. For the first round. Then every time after that, it starts at midnight. But we were messing with the headphones, because I wasn't getting audio. And right as Ryan's like, all right, you're good. I'm like, okay, cool. I'm wearing them. I'm joking around. I'm like talking. 15 seconds later, I get fucking killed for the first time. And it startled me so much. I like jumped back. And I didn't even think about it at the time. But it wasn't until the next day I got up and I like couldn't go down my stairs because I did leg day the day before. And I'm like, that's fucking why I collapsed. Like, I jumped and my legs just buckled because I did leg day that morning. I literally just collapsed on the fucking floor. Like, the second time I died, I fell. Like, I just dropped down intentionally. The first time I die, it's 100% just my muscles failing. I just fall on the ground. I mean, that's legit. I did not crouch down. I just fell onto the floor.
It's been, I think, quite a good week or month of
content. It's been a great
month.
Yeah.
I've been, like, really happy with everything that's gone up.
We shot, I'll say, I don't know when it's going to come out. It's going to be long as fuck, but we did a PlayPals in Manuel Samuel. Gabe Jeremy recommended us to play.
So good.
It's, it's like this weird, like, almost quap-ish, like, Octodad controls, but it's just like a story-driven game. It's a side-scroller where you go left to right, but essentially you have to manually control all the guy's body parts. So Gavin has half the body and I have half the body. We're playing on two controllers.
Yeah, you're
so I have to,
the blinking.
I have to blink, so if you don't blink for so long, the screen just gets like whiter and whiter.
I have to breathe in. You have to breathe out.
I have to breathe out. I have his spine and his right leg. You're the left
leg.
The
spine is fucking annoying.
You're just walking and then he just collapses backwards. And it's just like crunch, and then you gotta straighten him up and he goes crunch and comes back.
There's one bit where like, I'm in control of the head too. So I'm brushing the teeth, and it's all getting fuzzy. I'm like, blink, Michael, and then I'm turning blue, so I breathe in while I'm brushing the teeth, and it's like...
and even like, the narrative to the game is hilarious. It's really funny. Like, there's a narrator the entire time just, like, talking about what you're doing, and what the hell's the... Samuel's the name of the guy. Like, at that point when you breathe in, the guy will be like... And then, like an idiot, Sam forgot that he can't breathe while he has water in his mouth. It's
and then
really
you have to, like,
funny.
Time it to choke the water out.
Did you try to drink coffee? Drinking coffee's fucking hard.
I think we actually exhausted the coffee machine.
We did one. We went to drink coffee, and we were drinking it, and I think first we dropped it or something.
I think we put it in and didn't swallow, or it was too hot.
Then we went to drink it again, and the spine snapped, and we went like and threw it over our head, and it was like, and the coffee just went over our head. Then we got the third cup, we blew on it, but I blew too hard, and we passed out on the floor. So then we got up to get a fourth cup, and it was empty.
Yeah.
So we did not successfully drink a cup at work. It's like, damn it. But usually, I mean, like, the whole reason we did Outlast as a Let's Watch is because we knew we were going to play the whole game, and we knew it was longer. I'd rather not have seven play pals come out in a row that's the same game. So a lot of people were like, why isn't this play pals? And it's like, well, because we're doing the whole game, you know, and we don't want to, you know, play pals usually means a different game. We've done part two on some games. That's it. I don't think we've ever even done a part three in play pals. So we did this game as a play pals, and 30 minutes in, we realized there's really nothing to cut. It's just you and I being incredibly focused because every 2 seconds, somebody fucks up. Like, if you try, you have to walk right, left, right, left, right, left. And if the right leg steps forward, but then you hit right leg again, he just falls on the ground and does a split. And you have to get back up again. There's that also, was the first 10 minutes of Gavin.
Once you've got all that down, then they throw you in a car that's manual. And then you're dealing with, like, the pedals and the clutch. It's like, oh, you're passing out because you're not breathing. Oh, damn, I gotta breathe. So you end up just playing like this.
I control
and not saying anything.
Gavin controls the clutch, I control the brake and the gas, but I don't control my leg, so when I have to go from brake to gas, he has to move my leg for me. It's insane. It's really fun, actually. Yeah. It's a fantastic co-op game.
I was like, as I was playing it, as soon as I started it up and saw, like, oh, single player, multiplayer, I was like, oh, there's a multiplayer? And I started playing it, I was like, they gotta do play.
Yeah, Jeremy was like, you gotta do it. Guys, you gotta do it. Well, that's why we did it, and it's awesome. It's a great game, so that should be coming out soon.
Yeah.
Speaking of other videos that we've made recently, I watched this morning the beginning of our Skyrim Let's Watch.
Awesome. That's a great one.
we were loading up the game, and the theme tune was already playing, and it was like past all the good bit. So we're like, oh, let's just we'll start the video. Let's wait for the music to come back around and restart the theme tune.
We could probably move this at this point.
Yeah,
so we can rock out to the you know the amazing chorus in the Skyrim theme.
Yeah.
But without discussing it, at the beginning of where the Dovahkiin chant starts, we all bob our head.
Yep.
Now, all four of us, without saying, let's do that, we all just go...
It's
and
funny
I start
too.
Laughing because we're all doing it.
It's
I was
funny.
Like, how did we do that?
Because obviously you were behind me in the video, and I noticed, like, I did it right as Jeremy did it because he was slightly in front of me, and I could see that, and you burst out laughing, and I thought you were laughing because the two of us were doing
it. Yeah, same.
Not until even the video did I realize we all did it. You just lost
it
immediately. It
wasn't even like two people did it, and the other two joined in. We all
went on
beat one.
It was all the exact same time.
That was like...
my mic wasn't plugged in.
No.
Yeah, that's
so
great.
We do the whole thing, and I'm like yelling and screaming, and you're like, someone's not plugged in.
Yeah,
oh, whoops.
If you watch my face during most of that intro, I'm looking up at
you're
the screen.
You're going like that.
And I can see something's off, but I don't really know what it is until after we're all done. I'm like, oh, there's only three waveforms. The fourth one is nothing.
Hey, I still picked up.
Yeah.
I was doing my best during that whole Skyrim thing to keep a straight face the entire time, and the only time I broke was we kept doing this, and then it was the first time they go... Yeah, like that, and Ryan went to do it, but didn't start early enough, so he just got the end of it, so he just went, ah!
And I laughed, I burst out laughing again at that.
Laughing.
And you were doing some crap at the front where you were like,
I did the coin move.
He threw a bunch of coins in the air.
And threw them in the air, and then they were coming down.
I saw you doing that live. I was like, I don't know what he's doing. And then we looked back, and you're like, oh, I'm doing my coin
move. I was watching something I grabbed from you. I was like this, and I grabbed it from behind you at the last second. I feel like we all just fell into some sort of theater.
It was a weird trance
right there. Yeah.
How much of that made it in?
All of it.
Most of it.
The gaps are cut out.
The gaps are
I like
just
that
like
there's basically an invisible button when we start a video. It's like, well, the video is clearly started. And we all just go into just insane mode where it's like, we're all just so into it and we don't discuss it, but it all works out great.
It's like you start a podcast and then just like a pumpkin gets punched and just.
I think
that's what it took to get you to switch from water to beer.
Honestly, there's not a water tap. I'm like, I guess I'll just fucking drink beer. Damn it.
I think actually at the end of the video too, there's like kind of bloopers of of us like all sitting there and we're about to get started and you're like, no, we gotta do this song. And then we're like listening to it and we're like, no, it's the end of it, bring it around again, like us waiting for the song to restart.
Yeah, we waited for like 2 minutes just staring at the screen for the song to reset.
Well, before we started, we were having the argument. Well, you were out of the room, but we were having the argument about how that's the same theme through all of the Elder Scrolls. Well, I think from the third one. From Morrowind, Oblivion, and Skyrim.
No, yeah. It was even the other one, right?
I don't know about Daggerfall. Oh. We just made jokes that it was like some kind of weird MIDI version, probably.
Yeah, but they all get like progressively more epic as each game goes on.
Right.
And Skyrim is just the best version.
It's Morrowind was very tame and like...
Yeah, Morrowind was
melodic.
Like,
and then, yeah, it started to kick in a little bit in Oblivion.
I mean, Dragonborn. Skyrim added the, like, hard, like, rah!
Yeah.
Like, all,
yeah.
like, the chants. Yeah, I don't know. Viking type.
It's got that, like, table pounding kind of, like, chorus to it.
What's this?
Daggerfall?
Yeah, it's different.
Nope.
So I guess it's just all the console versions.
Well,
they started.
Morrowind was only PC, right?
No. Xbox.
No, it was Xbox.
Did they have an Xbox?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh.
On the original Xbox.
Yeah.
Huh.
On the black Xbox. It's funny, I played it. I hated it. I was like, this game sucks.
Wasn't
Morrowind
giant?
I didn't even realize it was.
Morrowind was pretty
big. It was an Oblivion or an Elder Scrolls game. I had no idea it was a series, any of that. So a friend of mine had it. I'm like, this sucks. And years later, I got 360. I bought Oblivion, having no idea it was the same game in the same franchise. And I fucking loved Oblivion. And I was like, that was the same game? So I don't know if they're that different or just like my child brain didn't like it. And then 6 years later, when I played the next one, I really liked it.
People seem to fondly remember Morrowind. It was like a great game. But yeah. I didn't play that. And honestly, Oblivion was kind of a chore to me. Skyrim,
Oblivion was the first one I ever played. I mean, it looks like dog shit and it's definitely a chore, but I had a lot of fun playing it.
So did you buy it? The remastered version?
Skyrim. You were contemplating yesterday whether you're going to buy it or not.
I did.
Did buy it.
Now, you were telling me yesterday when I was walking out.
Fuck you.
That it released at 6?
The what?
Yeah, 6 p.m.
I guess that was in the UK. Because in the UK, midnight is.
It wasn't until midnight.
Shit. It was out for 11 p.m.
On Steam.
Oh, really?
Everything's
always out at 11 here.
On Steam.
Well, that was why it was surprising, because like I said, it's almost. What the fuck is that?
That's just the wind chime.
What the fuck was that?
What wind chime?
It was my phone.
That was loud as shit.
God, Jesus.
Yeah, because you were saying it's coming out at 6 p.m., which was confusing, because almost every single console release, PS4 and Xbox One at least, comes out East Coast at midnight.
So, I don't know, someone else in the room said it was coming out at 6.
Well, no,
like,
Steam, it did release at like 6 or 7.
It did.
Yeah,
on Steam,
I was like, I guess that's midnight UK time.
Hmm.
I didn't know about console.
It is actually a sweet advantage, because I grew up my whole life living on the East Coast. So now with, like, digital downloads here, I feel like I'm an hour ahead. It's like, 11,
That was one of the shittiest things when I first moved to Texas was, and that was before digital download was as big as it is now, is you buy it and it's like all my friends on the East Coast were playing it an hour before I could buy it. I'm like, I want
to
be in.
Oh, like buying games at midnight.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I used to do that for
like
every
Halo
huge
releases,
game. Yeah,
yeah.
Every Halo release, I went to a midnight opening. I did it for, like, the first 2 or 3 gears. I've been to, like, probably 20 midnight releases.
You want
to
hear some absolute insanity?
Sure.
Halo 3 came out 2 days later in the UK than it did here.
What?
That is
Why?
Insane.
That's...
Or was it Halo 2?
Did you just cry?
Might have been Halo 2. I think it was the 9th here and the 11th in the UK. It was absurd.
Brutal.
Yeah. So, and I'm glad that the internet has united the world on release times.
Right.
Like, the Super Nintendo... Nice. Games would come out in Japan, like, a year before they would in
Or they'd
North
just
America.
Never come out here.
And sometimes never.
Yeah.
Like, Or and then sometimes games would come out in North America and not Europe. Like Earthbound never came out. Yeah. Earthbound came out in Europe in 2013 as a part of the Wii U or the Wii.
Same thing in America at some point. Like they re-released it like a couple of years ago. And it was with all the Final Fantasy games. Like America got half of them and then they fucked everything up because they just renumbered them all. Because like we got Final Fantasy 1, didn't get 2, didn't get 3. Then got 4, and instead of calling it Final Fantasy 4, they were like, that'll confuse people. Fuck it, call it 2. And they did that twice. Then we didn't get 5, we got 6, so then we called it 3. So that was, there was Final Fantasy 1, which is Final Fantasy on Nintendo, 2 and 3 on Super Nintendo, then PlayStation came out and it was Final Fantasy 7. People were like, what the fuck? Like, Final Fantasy 7, they just went, fuck it, we're shutting it down, it's 7. We're not calling it 4, we're packing it in. We're catching up, and then over the next 10-15 years, they ended up re-releasing everything digitally or on like Game Boy Advance or blah 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 blah. But it was pretty silly for a while.
And people realize they missed nothing.
In the UK, I'd be playing Super Smash Brothers with my friends. We'd be like picking all the characters, and then we'd all be like, "The hell's Ness? What is that? I've never seen that in my life." And none of my friends knew what that was because Earthbound just never came out there. It's weird. Such a weird decision.
Yeah, like Earthbound is Mother 2 or 3 or something. I think it's Mother 2. So we never got Mother.
But did Mother 3 then become Earthbound 2?
I think so, because that's the one with Lucas. There's Ness, and then they added Lucas, who's like, he's like the protagonist of the next game.
Mm. Oh, so what happened to Ness?
It's just like totally different characters. It has nothing to do with it.
Didn't die or anything?
I don't think so. I think it's just like a completely separate thing. They're just like, fuck it. Like Final Fantasy, we're just like, it's the next one in the series, but it has nothing to do with the other characters. Ness, I think, is just like the most famous character. I don't know who the hell the character in Mother 1 is.
I still don't know who
the hell. Yeah, I know, I know.
Role-playing game.
Ness. Nice. Sure. Earth.
My bound.
He's got a yo-yo, bound? And he goes, PK Fire! He shoots PK Fire.
Is that true? PK Fire?
PK Fire.
What's the PK stand for?
I don't know.
Pyrokinesis?
He does have, like, telekinetic stuff, so it probably actually does stand for that.
Wow.
But pyro means fire, so he's saying fire, kinesis, fire.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't have to make sense. He's, you know, he's like 10.
Whenever I have to yell and make fire come out of me, I'll yell it.
You're not wrong.
Yeah.
What about I had sex with children?
Deal.
You would yell that?
I'll be a...
In public?
I'll be an on-fire pedophile, whatever.
I mean, I think he's saying you're not actually a pedophile. You don't actually have to have sex with children. You just have to say it.
I have to yell. But, I mean, everyone will think that of me.
Still, you might as well do it.
That's true.
No, I'm saying it's just like, that'll be my stigma. So I'm a mystery.
My stigma.
Every power comes with a price.
Right, I'm just
your price is social awkwardness. He's like,
no.
No,
if you guys are gonna call me a pedophile, and then you know what's the point?
Hey, don't put words in my mouth.
That was one of my
don't put kids in my mouth.
That was one of my darker $1 million butt scenarios. Was that you get $1 million and you live your life just fine, but when you die, it comes out that you're just the biggest child predator that ever lived and ever walked the earth.
Even though you weren't. Yeah,
you'd
your
be
legacy will be destroyed.
Everyone would think you're a Jimmy Savile.
I'm good.
I don't know. I might do
but
that.
But your life, as you
I'm
live
dead.
It, would
I don't
be,
give a shit.
Nah. Yeah, but what if you have kids?
Yeah, well, your family.
I won't.
Well, then you're
you
good.
Said I'm going to live a happy
well,
life,
then you're
right?
Good.
Then I clearly don't have kids.
Ouch.
Look, kids bring a lot to your life.
A lot of diapers.
Like comments like that.
They do.
Yeah. How worried are you about like hearing like the Jeff stories with Millie? Like approaching the preteen teenage years?
That's...
Oh.
Do you think it's going to be as bad or no?
And I have two of them.
I know, right?
Least,
I feel like you have twice the chance, though, to, like, ally at least one of them with you.
Well, the trick is to get, yeah, to, when they're going, they're going to, there's a couple years separated, so they hopefully won't hit that phase at the same time. Like, one will have 2 years of puberty under the belt when the next one hits it.
Uh-huh.
And maybe they're, but it's a male and female, so I imagine the process is very different.
Who do you think will have a kid next? One of you two or Ryan?
I'm done.
I always say that.
I need to get the surgery. I need to have the snips. I'm doing it. I don't care.
When?
Man, it's hard to find time to go do that, though.
I don't think any guy
like,
wants to do that.
You just want to slap your testicles
I mean, apparently
on the counter
it's pretty
and have
easy.
Someone go. Yeah, it's bare. It's like they
just
tiny
like,
little
in
thing.
And, out. And you can undo
they just go
it.
In. Yeah, it's they
like
just
Michael
ligate
Scott.
It.
Just keep.
Yeah, snip, snap, snip, snap, snip, snap. You said you don't have kids, so I had a vasectomy. And then you said that you did want to have it, so I had it undone. And then you said you did it, so I did it again. Snip, snap, snip, snap, snip, snap.
God, three vasectomies.
Do you know what three vasectomies does to a man?
The office is great.
I'd do it if it was like, no more kids coming out, or if I didn't have kids or anything like that, as opposed to tying the tubes. It's easy as shit.
Supposedly, it's only, like, you're down a weekend, and then you're back in the game. I mean, you can't test it out for, like, a month, because apparently those sperm really hang in there for a while.
Oh, yeah.
Like, no more will get out, but the ones that are still loaded in the tube may kind of hide in there for a while.
That's why pulling out only works once, right?
Yes.
Only the first time.
I see where you're going with that. Yes.
Sort of, yeah.
Yeah, unless you really wipe it down.
The second one's all mucked up, though.
Like, what do you mean?
Your odds go down. Well, because if you do once, then you've got like the cleansing juice that kind of pushes all that out.
Pre-cum.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's pushing out what's in there, though. It's like,
there's also sperm in pre-cum.
Yeah, I know. There's not. I know. But
I mean,
there's not.
It mixes.
You can get pregnant from just that.
Pre-cum contains no sperm,
but it can scrape from your previous.
That means it's in it,
right? But if you haven't jizzed in like a week, there's no sperm in there. It's all dead.
Apparently, if you have a vasectomy, you can still impregnate a person for 30 days.
I'm sure. That's
so if you haven't jizzed in 30 days, sure.
I'm sure that's caution. I'm sure it's really like a couple of days.
Yeah,
we'll say 30.
Cover our bases on the dick snip. You don't want somebody coming in and getting their dick snipped and then being like, all right.
Well, sperm.
What the hell?
Sperm can hang out for a while. Apparently, that's how you get a girl. Supposedly, the boy sperms are the
ones. That's how you make a girl. That's what you're saying. That's how you get one.
The boy.
Hey, baby, my sperm's been lying around forever.
Sperm hangs around. Old sperm. You want some of this? The boy sperms are like the fast ones that get in there. Like they strike hard. They're right off the bat. The girl sperms take their time, but they last longer. The boy sperms are all dead, and the girl sperms are still there.
It's same with fights.
It's the same like life.
Yeah. It's like a boy fight. You go in and you just beat each other up. A girl fight, they fuck with each other.
Dude, there's hair.
Yeah. Mental.
It's all mental.
Shirt tugging and shit.
So if there's like an egg there, the boy sperm are like, nailed it. If there's not an egg there and it has to wait.
The boy sperm go, missed it.
Yeah, they're like, we tried our best.
I think, you know, Ryan could do one more.
No.
Come on.
I don't have the house for it, man.
Well.
Or the cow. Do you know what the leap between two kids to three kids is?
No, that's, I don't know what the leap to one kid is.
It's like a new house.
A car has five seats.
Every car?
Not car seats,
standard
though.
Car, sir.
Well, I mean, most cars. Some have cars.
There are very limited number of cars that can support three car seats
by the time.
It's true.
Eli, he's old enough to get out of a car seat soon, right? Eventually?
He's five.
I mean, the answer to eventually is yes.
I'm pretty sure Millie still has to sit in a booster seat, at least according to the law.
Yeah, I'm sure she doesn't.
I don't know.
But
I'm not 100% on that. But yeah, no, they have to be like,
according to the law,
five feet tall. And
you can't put a car seat in the middle seat.
Well, Millie should be good then.
You can on some cars, but they have to be big enough. Right now, I have two car seats, and there's not a lot of room between.
Car seats generally, like, you can do the end seat, you can't do the middle, and you do the other side seat.
But you can do the front. You just have to turn the.
You can't do the front. You cannot put a car seat in the front.
If you turn the.
I think that's they no-no'd that.
Oh, you're not supposed to do it ever.
Why?
Because I don't know. You kill kids?
They kind of went back on that.
Ah.
And they were like, just don't ever put it in the front.
Just don't do it. Yeah. So now what you have to do is either get a really wide car that you can fit three side by side or get one of those like third row seating vehicles where they got the trunk is like also seats.
It's like a smaller SUV really. Yeah. It's the ideal.
That seems like more dangerous to put a kid in like the trunk where a rear end would crush it.
Nah, they're good.
Yeah. All right. That's what they're made for.
You put the springiest one in the back.
Dude, the younger they are, the more they bounce.
Yeah.
It's just like, oh, your head's shaped like that now. Okay.
Yeah, it'll you just pop it back. It's soft. That's what it's soft for. I know. It's like Play-Doh. You mold it
it's
back.
It's
kind of
harsh
shape.
For the kid because the kid has to be born and live its entire life. But I really want you to have one more just for the effect it has on you as a person.
I know. That's what I was
it's
saying.
It's so good. If you could have another one just for our benefit,
that'd be great, Ryan. Gavin, give him $20.
Bet him
$20.
No.
I bet you $20 you won't have a kid.
But you were insane with your second kid.
Yeah,
you were a lunatic.
Yeah, you did lose your mind for a little. I don't even remember what we were shooting, but it happened.
Did it?
Yeah, there was some like delirium and insanity.
I have no memories from that period, to be honest.
Ryan's it's all blacked out.
It's all kind of gone.
Second to that, Jeremy, for sure. He's
Jeremy's next
triplets.
Triplets.
He just said he's not going to, so he can be a.
That's means,
not accurate.
See? He lied. He said that.
I'm
without,
not having triplets though. If he I said that without I'm the throwing one of them away.
There you go.
He said that without proper authority. Okay.
It's not up to me
you
in
can't
any
make,
way.
You
shape,
can't make
or form.
That call. Completely.
Are you worried that your kids will be able to watch all the insane crap?
Am I worried? Not at all.
Yeah, I don't give a shit.
I don't care.
There's content filters.
Because also my immediate answer will be like, thankfully everything I've done on the internet has been in my 20s and later. Oh, so right, there's never a, like, well, you did it. Fuck you. I did it when I was 25. Shut up. That's it. If I started, if I had shit when I was like 15, I'd be worried. But I don't, so I'm fine with it.
No, like hidden porn career back in the.
No, I mean I just start. Yeah, no.
It's
not
just
that I'm aware of.
In the, if I want to watch a video of my parents as kids, I think there's one. For me, there's a couple. There's thousands.
It's a couple dozen.
This is crazy.
I'm sometimes concerned that I'm not videotaping my kids enough.
Yeah, fuck it.
They're gonna grow up and they're like, what? Didn't you love us?
It's something I've become really accustomed to in just a convenience kind of way that doesn't apply to most people, where like I can be talking to someone, whether I'm home in New Jersey talking to my family or like telling my trainer about something at the gym, you know, literally anything. And we were doing immersion the other day and we wanted to take a picture based on some other picture, and we're talking to the photographer about it, and he's like, well, how was it like? And I'm like, just type this into Google. There it is, first result. Like, I love doing that. It's such a convenience that's not a normal thing. Like, type Michael Jones off-topic haircut. Yeah, cut my hair like that. Like, I'll do that at the hair salon. I'll, like, type in my name and, you know, off-topic. Yeah, cut my hair like this.
Yeah, it's not
it's such
a it's
fucking
not like
convenience.
A celebrity. It's like, this is me 3 months ago. Make it like that.
Yeah, literally. I do that all the time. It's so convenient. I'm like, just look it up. Just look up whatever. I sometimes forget, because all of us and like our most of our lives, like Ryan, I would say, is the most separated. When he goes home, he has a normal life with his wife and children.
I try.
Yeah. You're losing it a little bit with your streaming.
Do you not think your life is normal outside of work?
No, I mean, I might live here 24/7, even when I go home. Like, this is all Lindsay and I talk about. She works here. You know, we have no kids. Like, our whole life is here. So.
You, Lindsay, and Andy.
Just yeah, who also fucking works here. You know what I mean? It's just like more in, just all in. So sometimes I, you know, you have the exact same, you know, advantage or possibility or whatever. Like, well, Gavin can just type up or whatever. When I exit that bubble, it's like, oh, right. Yeah, like I can't type Denise Jones headshot and get a fucking picture of her. I mean, maybe now it would probably be on this podcast. But it's weird. It's weirdly convenient for like really small things that just like everyday life. I'm like, oh, this is useful.
I think the amount that I video my cat,
you do
means
a lot.
That if I have a kid, there'll be a lot of footage on it.
I can't imagine you having a child that was not documented extensively.
Yeah. It's true.
Slow mo.
I mean, the kid will be like strapped to a camera.
I feel like anything bad that happens to your kid will immediately produce evidence.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering what you did earlier.
What's insane, though, is that this... Yeah, I'm sorry about that. It's like I got a 256 gig phone.
Yep.
And, you know, it's low bit rate.
Is that a dry phone?
It's dry. I was just thinking, there's a lot of videos of me as a kid. My granddad used to film stuff like crazy. He had Hi8 tapes. You get like 90 minutes on him. And I've never run an iPhone, just press record and let it fill up 256 gigs. But it's got to be like hours and hours, right? It's just insane that... Without even buying a camera and a load of reloadable tapes, we can record for longer than all of that technology without even buying anything else on the phone. It's so convenient.
Yep.
So if there aren't a ton of videos of my kids, I feel pretty bad about it. I had the technology. I was just
lazy. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, I feel bad sometimes. But you're like, nah, I'll experience it and I'll remember it. And then you forget it.
I don't really agree with it. Oh, everyone who's looking, filming it isn't experiencing it for real. Because I feel like you still
Well, people say that a lot, like, at concerts and stuff.
Yeah, but it's like...
That's...
You know your own memory. I know I'm not going to remember the fine details of this. I'll get, a minute of video, and then I'll put it away. But I'd rather have the video to be like, oh, yeah, I was there.
Yeah.
And it's the same with, you know, little moments like that. I want to remember them. I'm not going to remember them. My phone will. How often do you film your kids?
It's a lot less. Like, with Eli, we did a lot more. So Livy's gonna have a little bit worse of a time because
you were less excited about
it. Didn't you give a shit about me? Thanks, Dad. I thought about that and got my phone out and filmed her playing with bubbles the other day, just because I was like, "There's one for you."
Here's one.
There's a period in your life where you just didn't appear in pictures.
I like the idea of Ryan's planning.
Is like on the piss because he's clearly watching TV at the same time. He's like, ah, great, look at that bubble.
He's planning already for when she's complaining at 8 years old, but there's no videos. I got the bubble one. Hang on.
You gotta stamp those out. Yeah.
Let me find it.
Like, why has Eli got 7 videos for everything he did? Well, he was It was novel.
He was new.
Yeah. I mean, you came along, we were like, nah, we got this. It's that thing again. Yeah.
Technology will be good enough at that point to make Eli look like her.
Well, here's the thing.
Say, oh, it's the same.
I'm actually in pretty good shape there because they were very similar looking, like nigh identical at a certain age.
I mean, it really, you get down to do some face swapping.
Yeah. Like, easy. No, that's you.
Yeah. Like, you go. You don't remember that? It's so weird.
Snapchat, solving parental crises everywhere. That was you.
Yeah, just put the puppy dog filter in it, right?
You don't remember when you were a dog?
Yeah.
What?
Really weird phase.
Yeah, when you were a baby, of course you don't remember.
That technology's gonna get out of hand.
Yep. Is it not already?
It's getting there.
Yeah.
It's gonna be built into glasses and you're just gonna live life like that. You're never gonna see anyone.
I've decided that today you're gonna be Al Sharpton.
Dude, that'd be wild. Can I be Al Sharpton right now? Can you edit me into Al Sharpton for like the YouTube release? I'm Al Sharpton. I'm in jail because I'm protesting something.
Is he in jail?
I mean, he goes to jail a lot for like a week.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, I don't know how, if he's done it lately.
But he was always, I bet they're Sharpton. Real.
He's always yelling about something.
I bet they're real nice to Al Sharpton in jail.
You think?
Yeah. I feel like he's going to have an interview after that jail. Where if you're not nice to Al Sharpton, he's going to tell everybody.
Yeah,
nice.
He's also, I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure he's big on the, like, I'll hunger strike in jail. He does that, too.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Who the hell's Al Sharpton?
He's just like a guy.
The Reverend Al Sharpton.
Yeah, that's true.
Idea.
He's a reverend, black guy. He's, like, big advocate of, like, shit he cares about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'm going to strike about this, I'm going to protest
big
about
speaker,
that.
Like.
Is it good stuff, or is it insane stuff?
He ran for president a couple times.
It's more, like, partially insane, but not like, too crazy.
That's the problem.
He pisses a lot of people
older.
Off. That's
yeah,
a picture of him.
Yeah. He lost a lot of weight.
That's him old as fuck. Yeah. He was fat, like, most of his career. He's, like, a little, like, kind of chubbier guy. Mm. But he's just, like, pop culture reference. Like, everybody, you know, every late night show mentioned him. He was always in the tabloids and shit like that. Mm. Always yelling about something, getting thrown in jail about something. Again, for, like, 2 days or something. Like, disorderly conduct or something. I'm all right with it. I like him better than Don King. He's got crazy hair.
He does.
Apparently, he was a piece of shit.
Well,
stole everybody's money.
Took Mike Tyson's money.
Thanks for all your money, son.
So our office is ruined for the rest of the day, right?
It
might be.
We don't know.
We don't know. We're gonna find out when we get back there. It's like a mystery.
So our AC broke.
Our AC broke 6 months ago.
At the beginning of summer.
Yeah.
And we were roasting in there every day.
Yep.
And now that it's Halloween and it's kind of cooling down.
Yep.
Get the AC fixed.
Well, I mean, this is like the fourth time they're attempting to fix it. It's not like the first attempt. I don't even think it's broken. I think it's just we have too many cunts. I mean, it's just too many people and too many computers.
The kitchen. That's
I think that's
the
other problem. I think they're just installing more. They're like, how to leave?
More cunts? We don't need any more cunts.
We just doubled up on our computers, didn't we?
Yeah.
And Jeff quadrupled up.
Right.
Yeah.
Did that video go anywhere?
No, it didn't go anywhere.
It will eventually.
We should do something with it.
It's rare that we make behind-the-scenes videos that are actually behind-the-scenes videos.
This is
usually
a full-on BTS.
Usually it's like, hey, let's kick this or hammer
this.
The
pumpkin
or
thing we did yesterday. We live-streamed it and we filmed it, just fucking up a bunch of pumpkins.
But yesterday we made a video, the day before, about the actual setup of the Achievement Hunter office and how absurd Jeff's desk is.
Right, because we're starting to unify all the setups. And they're really good.
And pretty much the three of us have the same setup. Ryan's pretty close, actually, as well.
Mine was the model for your guys.
I think it's literally Jack and Jeff now.
Oh, yeah. I've had that for months.
Completely fucking out of whack.
So everyone used to use Shadowplay, which was like the NVIDIA.
See, that's the thing. Even not even everybody used it. Like, you were using Game Capture for a long time.
Yeah, I've had this setup for a long
time. Ryan had two computers. We all had one.
All of our shit's been different for a long time.
So, yeah, we used to just capture on the PC that we were playing on. So we'd be playing the game and capturing footage to it, but now we have a computer that runs into a capture card that's controlled by a different computer.
Yeah.
So now one computer captures the footage of the computer that's playing it, which I guess is more reliable, more
secure.
Yeah,
and we
less frame rate dropping.
Yeah. Much better for streaming.
So we have a very nice computer that is essentially just a console. That's it, just a game console.
Yeah, we have Xbox One, PS4, Alienware computer.
Yeah.
Like, those are all for playing games, and then we have another PC for capturing all of those.
So now,
also,
basically treat the
somewhere
PC
in
like
our office, your 360 just shed a single tear.
Well, actually, I do have 360, too. I just don't
Yeah, mine's plugged in.
I actually, mine is actually Jeff's more, mine is more,
Jeff
than does. It's part of that video. Mine is actually more relevant than ever now because of my streamlined setup. I mean, I think we've played 360 three times in the last couple of months, so we still use it, but mine was like smashed behind both my monitors, standing up awkwardly where you couldn't even open the disc tray. I'd have to like turn the whole console, open it, and then face it the other way again. But since we changed all the setups, I don't need my third monitor anymore, so I got rid of that, and I was like setting up my desk and everything. I remember looking at Jeremy and going like, you know what, I think I can put that guy back on the show floor. Like, I had so much space because I was done with my setup, and I went, I'll plug you in too. I like pulled it out, dusted it off. Now it's good. My desk has never been better.
In case we ever go back to
my desk has never been better.
We actually do though sometimes.
Jeff,
like if we ever play Fuel or we have to go back to Burnout.
Oh, we'll play Fuel again. Jeff just insists on not. I don't even know. He insists on being an asshole.
Yeah.
There's just no rhyme or reason to what he does.
I'm not sure why he replaced his Apple monitor. I'm not sure what the reasoning was there.
But I think it had some burn in, right?
Okay, but who replaced it with that?
That is a great question.
So for those who don't know, Jeff has the $8,000 Mac Pro, the bin, the little trash can. That's his main computer, which now that he doesn't edit or capture on, is just for email.
Yeah, right. For main computer, you mean main self-entertainment computer.
Yeah,
while
yeah.
Not,
not including his PC or his
right.
gaming PC. But the monitor he uses is an iMac.
Which is a whole other computer.
A monitor that contains a processor, a graphics card, a SSD. It is a computer, but he just uses the screen. He just uses the pixels of it.
Yeah.
So he's got an $8,000 computer plugged into like a $4,000 monitor, basically.
Mm-hmm.
It's insanity.
And then two
it's
computers.
It's insanity. You may think my desk is the most ridiculous desk
now
in the
room.
Now
it's Jeff's now.
Jeff's
it's
dining
Jeff's
room
now.
Table
yep.
is the most ridiculous.
It really
Yours
is.
Is no longer the most ridiculous, but that's in spite of you.
Right.
Like
you
that was done
here.
When you were absent.
Yeah, everything just kind of changed while you were gone.
And Jax is still kind of fucked up.
Although well, you Jax... were annoyed at me the other day when I put OBS on the wrong machine.
Well, not happy with
well, Jax. Well, Jax is fucked
it's
up
easy
because
to confuse,
right.
Jack wanted to hook his up as soon as possible, so Jack actually has all the same shit that we do. His just hooked up, like, bizarrely.
Yeah.
He made an unusual choice.
We have no consistency.
Yeah. Like, Jeff's is idiotic. Jack's...
But Jeff is still set up properly. It's just he's got an extra superfluous computer that makes no sense. But
he's
the
got
rest
three
of it is set
fucking
up
keyboards and three mice at his desk.
Yeah. But he is at least
no,
still configured
three.
The all same right. way that we
he
are.
He doesn't use
Jack
the iMac,
has gone off the rails.
It's just a screen.
Got it.
That computer doesn't get a monitor or doesn't get
it's
a keyboard or a mouse.
One keyboard sits on top of the other.
Yep.
One.
He does. He doesn't have the space.
You, yeah, so
he
when,
literally stacks his keyboards on his desk. So we filmed a 10-minute video of us just making fun of it and pointing out how stupid he is.
So when you kicked my desk in half, we've lost the cost of the desk. What was that? Probably $80.
Probably.
Yeah,
the desk
was
a piece of shit.
We lost a monitor. That was $187.
That was the most
We lost
expensive
a keyboard.
Thing. And a keyboard.
Keyboard's probably $20, honestly.
Yeah.
It was a shit keyboard.
Maybe
so
less.
We're down maybe $300. Jeff's desk alone is a bigger waste of money than you kicking my
desk
in half.
If I kicked Jeff's desk in half, and everything on that broke,
dude, it'd be like $40,000, including the table.
The table
which he would demand to be replaced
with another dining room.
He'd be like,
table.
I want the exact same setup. every like the last several weeks and months of changing has been like, we'll give you this PC, we'll take away this one, we'll give you this, we'll take away that, we'll do this and change that. Jeff's just been like, nah, just add it. Add it. It's all just piling up on his desk, a fucking empire. It just makes no
well,
sense.
What do you expect?
And,
he's still got the fucking toothbrush.
And he's here the least out of anyone.
He is.
So all the whoever sits at his desk is somebody like from the other room, and they're like, how the fuck does this work? Like, what the hell? Everyone that sits at his desk is confused.
You imagine if someone went to his desk and accidentally booted up the iMac? It would just be like an empty computer. He's like, who works here? Who's
it would come
desk?
It would like
it doesn't
breach
make any
the,
sense
the air
at all.
Like, I'm alive! Yeah. I've been here the whole time! No one would let me talk!
I can't think of a bigger... an iMac that has gone to waste as much as that.
You could launch that
remember,
one.
Remember last
Yeah, you
time.
Couldn't
oh,
do
yeah.
it because it was the big one.
I had the big
Somehow
one.
Michael will suffer for this.
Yeah, you're gonna hit me in the fucking throat.
Oh, dude, that works so well.
I can't. I don't know what.
What's he doing?
He's gonna squeeze it and, like, fire it off. He tried to do it last week, but he had a giant bottle, so he couldn't do it.
Oh! Alright, that worked way better than I thought. Yeah. Look at that.
What is that? Is that vapor?
Hang on. Yeah. Give me it.
You know, as the pressure rapidly drops, it also cools.
Yeah.
Science.
That was a lot better than last time. Yeah. And that was way cooler of a trick than Gavin did at the beginning of this episode.
Yep.
Gavin made so much stuff disappear, though.
He sure did. What a magician.
Like your phone under a wave of coffee.
So much so that no one noticed.
Ah, fuck, right off the
roof. That literally, like, the world just came at me. There was water, there was glass, there was coffee, there was a fucking pumpkin. I didn't even notice my phone was under it.
Yeah. I like it cuts to the wide and you're in the air prancing back.
Like, I was just, like, leaping like away from it.
A cat who saw a cucumber.
Damn it! I got a little hot there for a second.
You got hot. It was deservedly hot, though.
It was, because it was as also, always, it was on camera hot.
You don't want the thing to happen in the first place.
I know.
When it happens, and it happens exactly how you predict, you get hot.
And we're in the middle of the podcast.
We were at the beginning of the podcast.
Well, that's what I'm saying, it started. You know, if it was off camera, I would have been 10% less hot.
Oh, you were more hot because it was on camera?
Yeah.
I thought you'd be more mad that we didn't have it on video.
I mean, it was on video.
Right.
Yeah, but he's saying, would you have been more mad if it wasn't on video? Probably.
I would have been probably more mad internally, but I would have not have outwardly. I would have been like, well, that's fucking annoying, and been more actually annoyed. But because it was video, I'm like, you piece of shit, and I had to go through the whole song and dance of yelling at you, and then you knew what was happening because you slinked away. Like a piece of shit.
Michael, you're crawling into a cave.
You're pulling back the curtain in the same video. Come on.
I know.
Oh, guys.
Listen, I've seen him mad off camera, and it's pretty similar. It's pretty similar.
It's not Funhouse. It's live.
Funhouse is live?
Funhouse just went live.
Hey, Funhouse, fuck you. No,
what are you doing, Funhouse?
Dude, you know what? That's a great segue that you brought up Funhouse.
Yeah.
You know what I'm excited about?
What?
What's that?
Our sweet-ass Battlefield 1 war video against Funhouse.
I can't wait for that. It's so awesome.
Wait, there was a post. I'm trying to find it on the RT subreddit. So see if people think who's going to win.
Did you record that already?
We recorded it. Yeah, it hasn't come out yet.
Oh, you weren't in it.
No,
I was out.
No, you were not. It was
making a different Battlefield.
It was, so it was a sponsored video by Battlefield. It was Achievement Hunter, Game Attack, Cow Chop, and Liza Beam Lannon versus
g'day.
Funhouse, Creatures,
Kinda Funny.
Yeah. That's who it was.
All right, so early votes are in. Looks like most of the people are saying the audience wins.
But if they're correct, the audience will win. It's a good video.
And everybody else is... It seems like they're betting on us.
Because here's here's the thing. So I believe the way the video is going to work is every single group that recorded it is going to have their own video.
Right.
So there's going to be like seven or eight videos of each group's own perspective. We don't talk to each other in
the video. Yeah, because the audio would be a nightmare.
It would it's 22 versus 20. There's 42 people.
Because like it's not
in this game.
The four. Like who's playing in our office?
Achievement Hunter is me, you, Jack,
Ryan,
and Matt.
Trevor was in the room.
Was he?
Yes.
Yeah.
Trevor was in the room, and then there was somebody else in the room as well.
Matt.
I can't remember Matt. And then also Larry, Mika, and Andy played from the other room, but they're not in the video.
They're just in the game.
They're in the war.
Yeah.
And
they're
really,
in the war.
There was only. The squad size is five, so it was basically five of us and Matt.
Right.
He was there.
Matt was on another squad.
He has video, but he wasn't really
inside. So we all have our own videos, and then Kent, because he's a psychopath, is making some sort of monster edit of everyone's footage to cut between. So we don't interact with each other in the video, but like...
Can you multicam that many feeds?
Well,
he's
mixing the pre-multicammed.
Yeah, and also he's listening for, like, because the thing is, there's 42 people in this game. We know every single one of them. So anytime someone kills you, there's so many times that, Michael will run up and stab someone and be like, fuck you, Nick Scarpino! Or, fuck him up.
Yeah.
That was what it was kind of like when I played Battlefield early, except to be like, it's Zac Efron. It's Snoop Dogg.
That's fucking
cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah, like, there was one point in the video.
For me, it was just fucking James.
There's one point in the video where, like, I'm running, I'm fighting somebody, I die, and then Joe from Cow Chop fucking revives me. I'm like, thanks, Joe! He doesn't hear me, but I called to him, you know, so hopefully in the edit we can then switch to his perspective and see kind of what...
So what was the split in... Was it 2v2 teams still?
Yeah, it was 2v2. Yeah.
So who was on the Achievement Hunter team?
I just listed all of them.
It was Achievement Hunter alongside Cowchop
against
Game Attack and Laserbeam. Okay. Against Funhouse Creatures.
I was seeing it as a big list of who was in the video, but
It's just like, I guess it's Achievement Hunter versus Funhouse and then everybody else. Right. But I mean, essentially, I mean, it's called World War because it's all of us just fighting.
Yeah.
I'm not sure exactly when that comes out. Soon. It's coming out.
We don't want to say who wins.
Coming out. Coming out in a couple of days, I think. I think it's next week. But
it
was awesome. You weren't there because you were filming another Battlefield video. It's out now for PC, PS4, and Xbox One. And Gavin, you actually just shot a slow-mo guys for Battlefield, so that'll be coming out soon. Was it exciting?
Yeah.
Which is part of the sponsor of this episode. That was actually like a 4-minute sponsor conversation.
That's true.
Accurate, and the game is fantastic, and it was so much fun. That World War
sponsors.
There it is.
Fitting with what we talked about.
Dude, that World War video was the most fun I've ever had in a huge scale game like that. Like knowing even some of the people in the game, they had like weird gamer tags or names, and I wasn't quite sure who they were. But knowing that every single person in the game was from the Let's Play Network, it was pretty fucking cool.
Yeah.
And it's like it's a game where in Battlefield you have people riding horses, you have tanks, you have planes flying around. There's one great shot where there's a horse running around inside one of the houses. Like it's awesome. It's like one of the most.
We should do that in GTA.
We should do that in GTA.
Oh, okay. Guess what else just came out?
You shouldn't mention that in the middle of like the sponsor read for Battlefield.
But this is a part of your
read. This is related.
Look at the screen.
Well, I mean, the screen literally says like Battlefield.
Just in general, we should use the Let's Play family more.
Sure, sure.
Oh,
horse jousting Battlefield 1 just came out too.
Oh my god.
So perfect time to mention that.
Yeah.
So that's also a sponsor video, which we were happy to do. We came up, or I think Matt came up with the idea. Matt and I don't know who worked on it. But we did horse jousting. We got a private server, and we went head-to-head with horses and swords. And
I may have gone a little off my rocker.
Ryan went insane.
Ryan went nuts.
Beforehand, because, I don't want to spoil the video.
With 3 seconds into the video, I pretty much just went 100%.
The video starts with Ryan, like, challenge me! And he's, like, riding around on the horse being insane.
Yeah.
Ryan's such a gambler. But that was a ton of fun. Of, like, what character Ryan's going to be in, version of Ryan.
I hope you guys like that weird old-timey voice. There's a lot of it in that.
It was not as old-timey.
It was whatever it was.
It was very...
Gentlemen, prepare for
somewhere, and then it just kind of goes all over the place.
Recently, where you were dragging us to somewhere. Oh yeah, it was the Minecraft we just recorded.
Slender?
Nope.
All right.
But you'd get into character whenever something happened. You don't know what I'm talking about. It doesn't matter.
Dark Wars?
I don't know where you're going, man. You're confusing everybody.
The opposite is that other Minecraft we made where Ryan just didn't say anything for like...
The Chinese mythology.
Yeah, the mashup pack.
I kept trying to work on something to do and I couldn't... Like, I was gathering shit and I just couldn't find anything. And I was like, well, fuck it.
I would rather not do those mashup packs, to be honest.
They're kind of pretty to look at, but...
It's like... It's a video that you could fly around in like 5 minutes, but a Let's Play...
Yeah.
It's nothing.
It takes a while. You know what it is?
The problem with you, Gavin, is you have no imagination.
I mean, we can walk around in Minecraft, I'm sure. Is that entertaining, though? Do you like those videos?
I don't mind them. I'm fine looking at them. They come out infrequently enough where I'm fine checking them out and looking around and shit. I thought the Halo one was fucking cool as shit. That was my favorite one.
I mean, they're great looking.
Yeah.
Not full.
We just need to do something with it. That's the problem. If we're just looking around, it's like, oh, look at that, look at that, look at this. If we were actually like, let's build
the Great Wall of China, we have no idea. And then we go, this came out? Awesome. There's an idea.
We need to make a Minecraft, and it's like, fuck it, the pack came out, use the pack. It's just not nearly as effective as GTA.
Yeah.
Because like when something comes out in GTA for the last year and a half has fucking killed it. Like everything they put out is awesome. You haven't even played the bike stuff yet.
Oh, I did. I haven't played it in a video. I played it on a Rockstar stream.
Yeah, I mean, like, as part of our
You're not part of the game.
We made the Christ Punchers, Dawn of the Christ Punchers. But we have an awesome motorcycle left for you to pick when you make the video.
I've
heard about it. Join the gang. It's just so awesome. I love everything they added
to GTA. We didn't get to film it the other day. Jeff wasn't here.
Part two. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, it sucks when the leader of the gang isn't fucking here.
Yeah.
Ever.
Why would you make him the leader of the gang?
Because he did it. He went and did it. He bought everything beforehand. He bought the clubhouse. He bought all this shit. And he's like, I gotta cover. To answer your question, because we're stupid. We should have just not let him.
We could never.
We should have just said, no, you don't get to do this shit anymore. Fuck you. It should be me or Ryan or Jack or Jeremy.
GTA is fun.
Should never be Jeff. He sucks.
GTA, you can just have one idea, do that for a video, and then it just spawns seven other ideas in the same video.
Dude, the one we just shot was pretty fucking good. I don't know if it's coming out on Monday, but I don't know if it's this Monday or the following Monday. But
we promised not to go into the airport.
And then we never did.
We didn't go in the airport once.
What is it? The audience doesn't like it when we just bum around the airport.
Well, they don't like it when nine out of 10 free rooms are us standing at the airport. And I can't argue that they're wrong. Because
the
flying
in that game is fun, though.
It is real fun.
It's the best looking thing.
And also, here's the thing. Even if you're not at the airport, you have to go there to get a flying thing.
I mean, that's.
The flying
thing
is the fun. That's more of the escapist part of it. And here's, like, I can drive a car every day. I can't fly a plane.
Here's the thing. And I think they're fine with a flying element. You know, if you're doing something, you need a plane or you need a helicopter. It's when all six of us are in a plane the entire video because flying is fun.
Also, if we say involve a certain swastika-based company and they just keep blowing up the planes before we can take off and do the thing.
Well, yeah.
That didn't go.
That also happened. Yeah. But still, it's Funhouse. It's talking about Funhouse.
Yeah.
My favorite part about that video was Elise just could not for the fucking life of her get a plane and get it off the ground. So every time, she was like, it would be 5 minutes of her just going, I can't get one. I just can't get it. James would be like, all right, I'll land. He'd land, give her his plane, get another plane, and she would blow it up in 10 seconds. He did that multiple times in the video.
I like her so much because she's the closest to me. On the
Elise is fucking fantastic.
She's awesome. Nice.
Yeah.
We should stop giving the Funhouse compliments, though.
Okay.
Right. I don't even consider Elise as Funhouse. That's the thing. You know, she's better than
she's
that.
She's just there.
Yeah.
You know,
she's just kind of. We should fucking, like, take her from Funhouse.
I think James would have a problem with it.
I don't think he would.
No?
Look, I'll take James too. Get them both.
How long have they been together?
Decent, I don't know. Package deal.
A couple months at least, I think. I did say at least. I'm not wrong.
He's That's not.
No, no.
But I think what we should do, though, is play against them more in games that
we're
better.
Well, they want to play Overwatch.
No, we shouldn't play that.
We should play that.
We should play Overwatch.
We can just play it. Honestly, the reason people bring this up, the reason we haven't played Overwatch is we gotta have all six of us. We're gonna play Overwatch.
Yeah.
We gotta have the four of us, Jack and Jeff. And we're never fucking here.
Have we mentioned that the Battlefield 1 is we played on PC?
I don't think we did. It's PC.
It's on PC. So, yeah. I mean, this
although,
is
I mean, I think I played it with a controller.
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's the advantage.
It looks gorgeous. It looks absolutely stunning.
Any video we release in Battlefield's on the PC.
Yeah.
Like, even
thus far, I don't even own it on the Xbox One yet.
I own it on the Xbox. Man, I played on the PC the other day with you guys for, I forget why. Oh, it was just another video we were doing. We were doing a Let's Play. And, PC is insane. Looks awesome. People on there are fucking
good. Got fucking destroyed. Well, that's because I play with a controller because I prefer it. But if you're playing on PC with a controller against someone who's playing on PC and using keyboard and mouse and they're good, you get destroyed.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no question that the reaction's better, the speed's better, people are just better. I'm just terrible at it. I would rather take the handicap of a controller, but, like, when a guy's looking the other direction, I can fucking shoot him in the back and kill him with a controller. On keyboard and mouse, I'm like all over the place. Cause I don't play PC games. So
I've
it's
been
like,
trying to play.
It pisses me off that I can't kill a single goddamn person on keyboard and mouse because I'm terrible with it.
I've been trying to play Overwatch on PC, and the lack of auto aim is like you've got to get used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because having to do your own aiming.
It swings all over the place until you're like, I'm in PC mode. Here we go.
Yeah.
And then you get.
I've ever hit that mode in my life.
Actually, some of the best I've ever done in FPSs on PC was, I don't know, a decade ago when I didn't have a mouse that moved. I had one of those Microsoft Office thumbball mouses. It was like a big gray mouse with a red ball for your thumb. And I was just like really good with my thumb. You didn't move at all like this.
It's a trackball. Yeah, it's a trackball that's mounted on your thumb.
They don't really make those anymore, but it's pretty precise. It's pretty precise.
I wonder if anyone has ever done like an FPS with a Wacom tablet. I bet somebody does.
Oh, just like an artist.
Uh-huh.
Maybe we should see if Patrick should do it.
Ken's got one.
I mean, people do all kinds of stuff.
Ken has one. That's how Ken edits.
Yeah. That's how he does everything. Yeah. He just interacts with his computer.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a mouse.
Yeah, he's got that track thing.
And they make a mouse for the Wacom tablet.
that goes on top of it?
Yeah.
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 Have you seen
get the
that
wheel
Surface,
now?
Surface yeah. Studio with the little knob that you put on the screen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool looking.
And then, sure and then it plays like a remix of Willy Wonka's
yep.
song.
Yeah. That's I've heard so many more people talking about the remix of the Willy Wonka song than the computer.
Well, do you think we should get Jeff one of those as a monitor?
I don't think we should get Jeff shit.
I think we
Why
should
the
start
fuck
taking
would we get
Jeff
anything.
Jeff.
Just fuck it up.
I mean, Jeff's... Yeah.
He's got a 27-inch monitor just sitting there waiting for us to take
he
the
does.
Max away.
He does. It's been in the room
the
for like a
month.
Fully upgraded
one of those things.
Fully operational.
It's like $4,200?
For the studio?
14.
Yeah.
Fucking cheap operational.
Right? It's something like
Apple
that.
Apple just put out a bunch of Mac
Battle Cruiser,
that,
sorry.
Battle Cruiser.
Apple
Battle
had like a track thing.
Operation.
Dude, that Yamato cannon.
But when I say fully, like the full upgrade
okay.
of the thing of it, it's a lot of crap in that. It's like 32 gigs of RAM in that.
Okay.
In the full, that's a lot for probably whatever you're going to do on that thing.
What is standard RAM these days for good gaming?
16. Yeah.
It doesn't go up very much. Like, you can get a
processors
lot of RAM.
Haven't changed that much
yeah.
in a while.
I think I have 32.
I also
so I guess it's overkill for what I use.
I mean, there might be some benefits to editing. Other than that, yeah.
I think I need
a
new
game
power supply
do it.
For my computer.
Yeah? Oh, yeah, we're talking
I think
about
that's
it.
What it is. Yeah.
You just ram in that
I think
thing.
My phone still works.
I don't... It's not
good.
With shit games. And by shit games, I mean games that aren't very graphic intensive, like Papers, Please, and Party Hard, which I love, but aren't, you know, they don't take
waterproof?
A lot of power.
I mean, it should be. I got rid of the headphone jack, Ryan, for that very reason, remember? It's supposed
to
be more waterproof.
You can dunk them.
It's actually, it seems to be fine. I'm kind of upset. I was going to make you buy me a new one.
But Dead by Daylight, which I love to play at home, fucking, I'll turn it on, it does the start screen, and then the logo will come up, my whole computer will shut down. Like, fully shut off.
Have you got, like, some incorrect overclocking specs in there or anything like that?
No. And I mean, this is the exact same computer that I was playing Dead by Daylight on, like, 4 or 5 times a week, like, mm-hmm. you know, a couple months ago.
How do you see your power draw when you're in a...
It's not easy. That's power supply problems are something you have to kind of diagnose by side effect. It just, your computer starts acting like a spaz, then it's probably a power supply. It's either that or heat. Things that used to be fine, all of a sudden it's just like, oh, I'm going to sleep now. That's power supply. I just built a new computer at home to do streaming stuff, and my wife immediately demanded to cover it in stickers.
Why? Is it ugly? Ugly case?
No, I was explaining to her, I was like, okay, I'm going to build a computer, because, you know, I'm married, so I was like, I'm going to spend $800. Is that okay, lady
Laurie.
Wife?
What are you about to say? Is that okay, woman?
You say wife? I think he was going to say wife. Probably.
Yeah, no, I call her wife.
You ever heard Ryan talk? He would never in a million years call Lori woman.
Woman.
No, that's like...
not an expect
not
to wake up.
Woman is a disrespectful word.
It is
I guess
for
if
Ryan.
You
it is if you call... Well, yeah, if you call
if
a girl
you call your
woman.
Wife woman, it is a little bit.
You call a dude man. What's up, man?
Yeah, I mean...
Why is woman
you call,
derogatory?
No, you call, you call a woman lady, Gavin.
Right? Yeah, it's just different.
I don't know why, though.
I don't know. Honestly.
It is.
Yeah, I would never go, what's
no.
up, woman?
Yeah, we'll
I
do it
agree
ironically,
with you. It's
sure,
like, it has,
yeah.
like, a different connotation for some reason. But it's really just the
exact second syllable.
It has a different connotation because people don't say, sup, woman?
Yeah.
They say, I was talking to a woman.
It sounds so
I mean, that's
yeah,
why.
Instead of, what's up, woman? It's like, chill out, woman.
Oh,
yeah.
whoa.
That's. Yeah. I mean, that's why it's offensive, because that's how people have used it. People don't say, sup, woman? You just don't.
I'm bringing it back.
I mean,
bringing it
I mean if you want to, like, you know, start a campaign, what's up, woman campaign, you know, let's make it chill.
One of my favorite Let's Play moments is an old Assassin's Creed Let's Play where you go to kill somebody. I think you go to kill Jack, and he sees you coming, so he turns around. He just hits you across the face, and you go, ah, you slap me, you woman. That is one of my favorite moments. I was looking for it the other day, too, because I was just thinking about it.
That kind of different use of language is so fascinating.
Yeah, like, I love that.
So she was okay with the $800?
Well, I was like, she was like, what? No,
if I
why
can
would
put
you do
stickers
that?
On it.
Why would you do that? I was like, okay, well, so when you're streaming, you know, you got one computer doing streaming, and another's playing the game, and I run it through this thing called Elgato, and that takes all the processing load off one machine, and she's like, yeah, I get it. It's called the cat?
I was like, Elgato?
Yeah, it's just the name of the thing. She's like, all right, you can do it, but I'm going to cover it in cat stickers. Like,
fair play, she is a vet.
Okay, I guess. Thanks. I go buy the...
Maybe don't just cover all the exhaust. Like ports.
I asked her that very specifically. She was like, that's fine. Okay.
That was my favorite part about when you kick Gavin's desk in half. You know, the immediate scramble of, like, we have to clean this now. You know, we pulled the desk out.
Because we're in the middle of the raid.
Well, yeah. Yeah, not that
yeah,
day.
But I mean, yeah, we also like, wanted to clean it because it was
there. We were checkpointed. We were checkpointed, but that was
and
like...
we needed to shoot the next morning.
We had one day left.
So we dragged the desks out. We cleaned everything up. We did everything. But as like a temporary place for everything on Gavin's desk that didn't break, he literally covered every fucking inch of his PC with everything from his desk. It's like the entire... It's like every exhaust for the PC was just like... Gotcha! And it was like covered by shit.
I mean, that wasn't literally the whole fucking thing. I assume you did that.
I did do that.
Yeah. I mean, it was just fucking funny to look at it.
But like, we all knew it could have been a gap.
Like, the next day, we came in, and it was you had lovely Ryan there as your temporary desk, and everything was temporarily set up, and your PC was just... Every fucking centimeter was covered with shit. I was like, well, I'm sure that won't crash or anything.
The best thing about the whole thing to me is that, well, when you have an area of office space that's, you know, at a certain point, you need to hire a guy who's in charge of just the office facilities. Facilities manager, that man's name is
like
John Mace.
John Mace. Yeah.
And so he's in charge of, like, replacing a desk when it gets snapped in half.
Mm-hmm.
Jeremy and I each took one half of my desk, and we slowly walked it from stage four all the way to the dumpster.
Yep.
2 minute walk, maybe.
Yeah.
We each had one side of the desk. Lot. And we were just like, we were kind of speechless, to be honest. We were just like,
yeah, just Kevin was literally going
off camera.
Can't believe
like,
that happened.
Look at this. This is mental. And as we got to the dumpster, only one person saw us put the desk in the dumpster. It was John Mace.
John
he pulled up in his
truck,
and he was just he looked at us. He was like,
"That's literally all he did." He shook his head, and we're like, "Don't worry about it. We're just gonna throw this away." He goes, "Leave it there, I can use the legs." And then he threw away.
He told us not to put it in the dumpster because he could take the IKEA legs and put them on a different But of all people, of like 250 people, John Mace saw us.
It's pretty funny.
You know what? This explains a lot about why he still hasn't fixed our doorknob.
Oh, he hates us for sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he hates our
there
guts.
Was the
there's,
nose,
there's no doubt
then
about
there was
it.
The desk.
And then there was the pumpkin carving.
And the pumpkin carving.
Do you think he secretly sees
anybody,
this as like, oh, those scamps?
I don't think so.
Yeah, has anyone come forward?
Anybody find those knives yet, by the way?
One of them.
We found one of them?
Yeah, they scoured the grounds, Kent and
well, I saw
Matt
Trevor
Mika, I
rolling the giant fucking
Trevor,
magnet
yeah.
yesterday.
Yep, they came
after,
up with
which
one.
After
did
everybody
they find?
Left?
The inside one.
It's like a giant broom, but it's a magnet, where like it's a handle, and it's like a magnet that's
what's
this
wide. What's
it for?
It's like picking up screws?
I guess, yeah.
No,
yeah.
That's a good call, yeah. They yeah. Have
so is it just
buried?
It's like a construction equipment.
That's
yeah.
I assume that it is in the turf, or my other theory was that it went through the fence, bounced down to the sidewalk, stabbed in someone's leg, and they just walked off with it, assuming
yeah.
that the knife had chosen them.
That could have happened.
So we threw knives at these pumpkins yesterday on the live stream.
Didn't hit once.
I
no.
can't believe
didn't
no
get
one,
one like
hurt.
Stuck.
That was insanity.
Yeah, we.
That were
kind of sad about
well,
that.
Well, I kept like
I'm out of practice.
I kept throwing them so light.
I hit
like
the pumpkin
really
like six times
it,
with a tomahawk,
in.
But I could never get it to like
stick
in
there.
I really
yeah.
wanted to
so
throw
anyways,
it.
So anyways, Ryan threw two of them. They went through the fence.
Dude,
which was amazing, by the way.
It was amazing.
Because it went through that back thing, and then behind that is a chain link fence. So the knife had to go through a diamond that size.
It did it.
Also,
and it went,
square.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it went, well, it's kind of, it's a diamond if it's on its side. Yeah, you turn it to square 90 degrees, it's a diamond.
Diamonds are longer.
It's still a square.
It's still a diamond shape.
You're talking rhombus.
You're rhombus.
No, rhombus is tilted. Oh, I guess if you turn the rhombus.
You're rhombus.
You're talking trapezium.
I need you to shut your fucking mouth.
Just shut the fuck up. Just do that. Jeremy sliced the fucking pumpkin with the sword I bought.
That was
super
awesome.
Super cool.
That looked really cool.
The riding
that
sword.
That was fun.
Andy filmed it in slow-mo. I think we
posted it
on
Facebook.
And it hurt
like hell.
I thought Mika filmed that.
Well, you put your finger
Mika
over
filmed
the,
it.
Onto
Mika
the blade,
filmed
dude.
It.
No.
Vertically.
I hurt my back.
So oh. then Andy oh. filmed, he saw her filming vertically, so he filmed horizontally so we could use it.
Yeah.
So there was two shots of
it.
My phone should really
oh, there,
this,
there,
is
there.
It. This is it. So this is Jeremy chopping in all the beautiful
Look, my hand's open
horizontal
the whole time, and
glory.
Then it closes right before. Oh, beautiful.
Your right finger, though, is on the blade.
Well, the handle on that thing's
kind of
weird.
I'm going to slice it. Oh, look at that,
Look at
Jeremy.
The blade turn after
And the pumpkin
it,
didn't even move. Not like when Ryan punched it and it destroyed everything.
Yeah.
That was clean.
We should have used
like,
a sword.
That hurt like fucking hell because of my back. So,
that, what hurt more, that or when you axe kicked the pumpkin twice?
Now, the axe kick of the pumpkin twice on leg day kind of hurt.
Yeah.
The back hurt more. Oh, the axe kick.
Alright, that was one.
So that was the failed one.
Yeah,
and how did you get your legs so high off the leg?
Gymnast, man.
I
used to be
a gymnast. Also, that, yeah, that really hurt. I was like, there
you
go. Alright.
You cracked it.
With ease, you can put your leg at head height.
Yeah.
Oh, they cut away. The viewers when we cut away. Jeremy picked it up and went, and he ripped it in half.
Like King Kong pulling the T-Rex's mouth. Or
so yeah, it was just like
all
that.
All week, in like physically, I've been worthless because on Monday, I went to the gym on Sunday, I think, and I haven't been to the gym in so long. Like, I've just started going again.
Yeah, you seem super out of shape. It's, I'm glad you're back at the gym.
Shut up. Did all piece of shit. All back.
I know,
like,
Lil J. I know,
you know, like, especially the ones where, like, you hold the barbell low, and then you pull it up to here, mm-hmm. and then drop it back down, so mm-hmm. it's, like, all this up here.
Yep.
So I was, like, I destroyed myself. Came in Monday, and we're filming Awu, and at one point I'm looking at Gavin, I'm like, I'm gonna pick Gavin up on my shoulders. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm just gonna do it. So went to pick Gavin up. Everything was fine. I was lifting him with my legs and everything was good. And then Gavin went like that and went forward. So I leaned forward and I was like, nope, I'm picking him up. So I tried to extend back up just using my back. And you can see in Awu the moment that I go, this is a mistake. So I get him up on my shoulders. I now know my back's fucked up while he's up there.
So would you pull a muscle?
I guess, or something. I tried walking around with you for a little bit, and that's why I just kind of fall onto the couch, because I couldn't put you down any other way. And then I saw someone saying something along the lines of, like, oh, like, look how fake Jeremy laughs it. Oh, yeah, see, I was on his shoulders there for a second, but they did a weird cut there. But they were like, Jeremy laughs so, like, fakely at Trevor getting hit with the blimp, like when Gavin hit himself with the blimp. They're like, why does he have such a weird laugh? It's because I can't turn my head anymore.
You're just like,
so literally, it's because I'm dead staring the camera, but it's because I can't turn my head enough to look at Trevor, so I'm looking at the feed on the camera to watch, like this, and then he hits Trevor, and I start laughing, which hurts, and I turn back like this, and Jeff's just dead staring at me laughing about it, so I just start laughing harder, and like... It was, yeah, so literally the rest of that, I was just like this the whole time. I don't know what video we filmed.
Also,
that.
When you dumped me off your back, I accidentally kicked you in the side of the
head.
You
did kick me in the head, but, I mean, that was fine.
Gavin's not to kick you in the head.
I beamed Trevor as hard as I could with that inflatable blimp, and I think somehow, I mean, surely the first hit is going to be the most powerful, and any rebound is, like, sub-powerful. I think when it rebounded and hit me in the face, it was even harder than Trevor.
It sounded...
It
rough.
Beamed, and the angle's totally wrong. You can't really even see it because I'm behind him. But I got blasted.
Yeah,
by
you got hit
right
with like a perfect counter. That was some seven deadly sin
and
shit.
And Trevor's
right
like, what happened? Now, did he get hit?
Trevor literally goes, did he hit himself? And he turns around.
Yeah.
And you unfortunately can't see it because you're right behind Trevor. I mean, you almost like knocked yourself
I
out.
I saw stars.
Like, you were like,
not like impact stars, but like shock stars of like, what? How? What happened?
The instant facepalm on Michael and that's so good, too.
I mean, I saw everything. I saw the whole thing happen. I was standing right behind him.
You have the best reactions lately to stuff. Usually, is this
it?
There
it is.
Look at Michael.
Wham! And then what? I slowly turn my chair back because I can't
Trevor,
turn my
Trevor
head.
Has no idea what even happened. He's doing a double take, like, what? And I'm just looking and I'm just shaking my head.
Yeah, one of my eyes is watering because it blasted my eye.
God damn, dude.
Because you react now so subtly, where you'll just be like,
so I've seen everything.
Yeah, it's true.
And then
like,
today,
Jeremy,
see,
the,
but today I didn't
see
this.
You'll just look at the camera, you'll just be like,
next time, you will have.
It's true. If when this happens again, that's the reaction you'll get. Yep. Yeah, when it happens
that's
again,
that's when I pulled out
like,
that clip from Worms, where...
I'm in the middle of talking.
The Worms campaign, it was, you know, we'd gone like half an hour into this level, and you were left and I was left, and I do this ninja rope, and I just plop into the water. It's like totally lackluster ending to everything I've done in that game. Everyone cracks up, but Michael's mid-speech, like, Gavin can go up there, he can then, oh, and then he can go and kill that worm. And mid-sentence, I plop into the water, and he's just like, never mind.
And so I was like, all right, so you can swing across over there, you kill that one guy, you come back, never mind.
And everyone's
going
crazy.
I just stopped talking.
Everyone's laughing like us, and you're just flat-faced, stone-faced, just like, never mind.
Dude,
never mind. You say it like three times, it's so funny to me.
Something like
why.
That recently was Ryan in the raid video. When the raid ends, mm-hmm. we kill him, and
yeah.
all
like,
five of us go,
and Ryan's like,
oh my god, Ryan goes, Wow, we actually beat him. What he says, he doesn't yell
or
anything.
I remember yelling. I don't know. I did yell. He didn't cut to me until after the yelling was over.
He goes, well, we actually did it.
It shows all six of our face cams at the same time. Everyone's like, ah! And you're like,
I don't remember.
It's awesome, dude. Wow. It's so funny. People are like, yeah, that about sorts it out there.
I don't think we've ever filled the waveform. Mia.
I don't think
unanimously.
I don't think I've ever been in a situation before where we were trying to legitimately complete something and thought we were never gonna do it more than that rate. Like, there's a lot of things we do. We play something on hard, and in 2 minutes I'm like, we're never gonna fucking beat this. We make a video of us dying for 45 minutes in it. But the raid, you know, we beat every other raid before. The expectation to beat the raid was there. We put the work in, we played Destiny a shitload outside of work, we all leveled up. Like, we were gonna beat this raid. We could have beat the raid. We put the time in. And I'm sitting there and I'm just like, we're never gonna fucking beat this. There's no fucking way. Like, you and I were talking that whole video about how it was never gonna happen. Because we had to shoot that before the podcast. And I just kept looking at the time. I kept looking at the time.
And I was leaving at the start of the podcast.
Yeah, so right. Yeah,
we knew
gone.
We could do it. We just didn't know if we had the time to do
it. Exactly. And it was like, all right, we have 45 minutes left to beat this. And we have not gotten further than 20 fucking percent in 15 attempts.
Especially
we're
with
never
the great Jeff.
Well, I mean,
those moments are so funny.
It was a combination of it was Ryan and Jack going at it in the video.
Oh, this is the end. This is the final.
And Jeff being
look at Ryan.
With
Ryan.
Everyone's going crazy. Ryan's just like great.
Like, everyone's screaming. We're all just going like ah. Ryan's like,
that's got to be from a different part of the video.
No, it wasn't.
That's
what
I won. It says mission complete.
Yeah, and Ryan's going. Wow, well, I can't believe he did it.
Like, that was the first thing I saw on the subreddit. I saw that on the subreddit. Somebody was like, there was two people that kind of said something. Because I remember on the subreddit, it was like, Jeremy, Michael, Jeff, Gavin. Jack something, and then Ryan. Huh, we beat it. Like, that was as soon as the video came out, somebody posted
there's also
that.
The moment where Jeff slides off the back of him.
Yeah.
And all of the lads on the bottom row all facepalm.
We all facepalm. That was the moment where I there was someone where I started just not caring anymore. Like, the Jeff part, if you listen to what I'm saying the whole time, I'm going, all right, Jeff, get out there, Jeff. You got this, Jeff. All right, wipe it up.
Fucking, that was actually,
not
the puppy dog one, as Jack pointed out when Jack was trying to, or when Jeff was trying to jump up and he kept hitting the side of it. The one when he cleared it full across, I believe you and I are standing right next to each other. It's in the back center. And we're like at the front center, so I have the perfect shot. I'm watching Jeff, and exactly in that, like, that worms moment, I forgot about that. I'm going, you got it, Jeff. You got it, Jeff. I watch him fly over, and I go, you don't got it, Jeff.
You don't got it, Jeff.
That's it. That's all I say. That's
so
all
funny
I say.
To me.
He's just
like the same.
You got it. You got
style.
It. No, you didn't get it. And I just stopped talking, and then we wiped.
So, what happened at the end of that raid? Did Enrage get to the point where he was just
know
about
what
to kill
does.
Us? Because it looked like instead of going to one of the normal points, he went to the center and did.
I think
that
might be normal.
That's
though.
Normal.
Like, that's normal.
When he gets to a sliver of health left, he just does that. And if you don't kill him fast
because
enough,
that's the same
wipe.
Move he does when he like floods the Siva and you have to be on the podium.
That's exactly
like,
why I thought
you're killing
wiped.
Me or I'm killing you.
That's why I freaked the fuck
and
out because I thought
died.
We wiped because my screen just started getting covered in shit. I didn't get shot with anything and I just died.
You died from his platform poison.
But that literally never happened to me once in the entire hours of us playing that.
Because
I never got that close. So when he disappeared at the end and then reappeared, I just like freaked out and I jumped at him for some reason holding
you
the cannon.
I think you were empowered and you were going to try and go for the
no, back. I still had the cannon and I was just shooting for damage. Like
one
of the shot
you
cannons.
You can do the slam with the cannon, can't you?
I know, I'm just saying I wasn't trying
to
do
the
slam.
Yeah, he was just trying to hurt
him. I was literally just like, ah, oh, there he is, kill him! And I just ran at him. Literally hit him and bounced off of him, landed on the platform, then jumped back up. And then I just died. But I'd never been poisoned once in our 50 attempts. So I thought we wiped. And I started freaking out. Like, I'm just like, no! And I immediately lean over and I'm looking at your screen. And then you beat him and I fucking lost it. Because he was 3 seconds from death. There's like hours and hours and hours of us trying to kill him. And he is 3 seconds from death. And I knew if we didn't kill him now, there's no way we're going to do
right,
it again.
Right, that was it.
Before the podcast. Yeah. And we actually did it, and I couldn't believe it. That was like part of why I freaked out, too. It's like, yes, I'm glad we beat the raid. We also beat the raid before Gavin left town. We also beat the raid before the podcast started. There was like 9 celebrations in
we
one
there. We
worked
incredibly hard to all be in that video without... because. I thought I wasn't going to be in the first part for whatever reason. The second part, I was also going to be gone. Instead, I took a red eye back from LA. I flew overnight just so I could be in that, and then I had to go somewhere else.
And then, in the final part,
I was about to leave again. So it was, and you're about to leave.
I had to go home.
You were gone for like a week, and we waited because we fought tooth and nail to beat it with all six of us for the entire thing.
That raid cost me like $400 in like changing flights and moving stuff.
Well, the audience thinks
just
it's worth
so
it.
I can be in the video.
I'm glad you were
because you know you get three parts. And it's like, I don't want to miss the final bit.
Yeah, I know. And we had that right side locked down. You know, as I killed him every time.
Yeah.
And you just kind of existed. It was really crazy how the raid started, too. You were the highest level, and at the end of the raid,
a reason why I didn't level at all since the beginning and the end is that I wasn't there.
Yeah.
I was literally only in the office for the raid.
It's funny because you and I were kind of together throughout the whole thing anyway, because that's how usually we'll pair up Team Nice Dynamo or whatever. And maybe it didn't even make sense throughout the raid because putting the weakest person with the strongest person is like a good balance, you know, so they don't like two weak people just get killed in a corner, like who are lower levels. But we were all kind of the same level going into it, but it actually made perfect sense at the end because I was the highest and you were the lowest.
And I was kind of doing stuff that didn't really matter. Like I would pick up all the
you were
ads
doing the
around
orb. Yeah, you were doing the ads and the orbs, like, and you had the shadow shot. And yeah. I was just, there was so much, orbs everywhere. I could almost super every single captain that came out, and the hammers just fucking destroyed them.
The hammer thing's cool.
I fucking love the hammer thing.
That's what I actually like.
I've almost
watching...
never switched ever since I got it for the Titan, since they added it.
That's
what I like watching
about our videos, in that I'm never gonna play another character. I only have a hunter, and that's all I've played, so I'm never gonna get all those Titan and Warlock ones, but it's nice to see other people use them. You can see them use them when you're in the game, but it's like you never see it from their point of view.
Right.
And that's why our videos are interesting.
I wonder there was an achievement, right, for getting to a certain level with each character class, but now they've got that token that just unlocks
it's the achievement is for fully maxing out all of the skills, and the Spark of Light doesn't do any of that.
Yeah, the Spark of Light just levels your level you up, to but it doesn't give you the abilities. Like Jeff, still not having self-revive. beat the raid, he's done with Destiny, he'll never have it.
I don't think I'm ever going to touch Destiny again.
Have you touched it since that moment?
Never played it since. Uh-huh. There's no reason to.
There's too much other stuff.
Even Jack, like day after, he's like, but 400 now, hard raid's out.
Oh, no, he's still playing.
Who cares?
He played,
but I'm like, who cares? He still keeps talking about it, and it's funny because we played it for weeks and weeks getting ready for this, you know, doing the raid, doing so many videos, and because it's the last raid of Destiny, we know there's no more DLC coming out before Destiny 2, it's like, well, it's over. We did it. It's done. It was done for all of us the second we beat the raid. And like 3 hours later, Jack's playing Destiny. He's talking about it. He's like, oh, I got this thing. And we were like, you're still fucking playing that? It's like the game is 10 years old now. You know what I mean? Like, what? Jack, I haven't beaten Fallout 4 yet. I'm not playing Destiny ever again. I'm sorry. I love it. Not going to play
it
again.
It's kind of sad, really. Like, really, I could delete my character right now, and I'm sure nothing bad would happen.
You should do it.
Well, what if you can pull something to
do? No, just delete your character.
That's what I'm...
Even though I think they've said that you can't.
There's also moments
like
they're probably lying, though.
You can also do Moments of Triumph, which is kind of a cool medal to have.
Yeah, but what do you get?
I know.
I never cared about the Moments of Triumph thing. And I never got
completionist.
It's cool. It's cool. I would have cared more if I constantly played Destiny. But I played Destiny in waves. You know, every time like a big DLC came out, I played it. I never played it in between those. So
you touched Destiny.
That
kind
of stuff I didn't really care about.
And I never will.
Yeah, Destiny 2, baby.
Moved on.
Seems about the good time.
The good time?
The good right time now.
Synchronize our watches.
Form of an ad read. This episode of Off Topic is brought to you by Movement Watches. You know I'm always on the lookout for some hot new gear. Well, Movement is hooking me up, taking care of all my new style needs. Movement has new bands and new watches to totally get you ready. Starting at just $95, it's that style that won't leave your wallet hanging. If you don't know what I'm talking about, then you have to check out their awesome content on Instagram. With their classy design meets styled minimalism, Movement watches are perfect for suiting up or going casual. Movement watches have tons of interchangeable band and color schemes that'll match your look perfectly. These watches look like they should be $400 to $500, but Movement keeps them at a perfect price point starting at just $95. If you're as impressed as I am with this watch, then join the Movement today. Go to mvmtwatches.com/offtopic, and they'll give you 15% off your entire purchase. mvmtwatches.com/offtopic. I'm getting a new one soon, and I'll wear it and show it. And
you don't
have
contacts yet?
I don't have contacts yet.
No, I was wondering why you were reading it.
Nice. Yes, because I don't have my contacts
cover up
yet.
That other thing.
And I'm not wearing my glasses.
I like that one. That's
I'm not wearing
one,
my glasses.
Right?
That are still broken. Swing, swing. Oh, it's Is this set correctly?
It's probably not, no.
I don't think Ryan gave it to me.
That's I have two of them. One
it's,
from Freeplay and one from...
six something right now.
This one is set correctly.
You're in the UN UK time?
Yeah.
7:43.
Do you think we should teach Jeremy sign language for all this stuff he does during the ad break?
I think Jeremy should learn sign language impaired. Himself. I don't know why we have
You're wasting your time.
Because you already
Neil
know
wants
it.
To use my computer.
Well, no, I lied. I think it is set right.
Is it?
Yeah. The second hand threw me off.
Ah.
Oh, so you just don't know how to tell.
I don't know how to tell time without my glasses. Pretty basically, yeah.
That's fair. When are you going to get those fixed?
I'm going to try it today, actually.
Try?
Well, we can't get back in our office,
I don't
maybe.
Know that they can fix them, so I'll try to get them fixed. If they say we can't fix them, there's nothing I can do about it.
Different frames.
No, well, I mean, the glasses are fine. My glasses fucked up. Basically, you know, there's just two screws on each side that keep the lenses in. The right screw popped out, and that happens from time to time with glasses. You just tighten it back up. But the hole that the screw goes through is stripped. So the screw just pops out.
You need a bigger screw?
So I would need, well, they got to tap it first, Ryan. They got to tap it and then put a bigger screw in. So if they can do that at Target, where I got them, then I'll just be like, hey, can you put a new screw in? Because they do it for free. I mean,
I want to go to, like, a... Do you think Target would have that kind of thing in there?
Well, I got them at Target. So they do it for free. Yeah, I mean, I've done it a bunch.
You're like a legit obstetrician. Not obstetrician. Optometrist.
Well, first of all, there's an optometrist, and then there's the glasses store. They're separate.
What's an optician?
They are, but...
I have no idea.
An optician's an optometrist.
No, obstetrician is the person that delivers
optician.
Babies.
I thought an optician is where you go to get glasses.
Optometrist is the person that does your eyes.
Yeah.
Christ is an optician.
I have no idea. Maybe that's like your crazy, funky British version.
I went to an optician a bunch.
I think you're right, Gavin.
Probably.
An optician.
Gynecologist?
No.
No.
OBGYC.
There you go.
What?
So you can see good.
Oh.
That's why I pointed out
optician.
My eyes when I said
optician.
See.
I don't know why I put an R in there.
I don't know why you did
optician?
Either.
Optician?
Optician. Got it.
What is an optician?
A technical... practitioner who designs, fits, and dispenses corrective lenses for the correction of people's vision.
But an optician sells glasses. That sounds like they don't give you exams. An optometrist gives you your eye exam.
No, they check your eyes in that.
It looks like they check your eyes, too.
So what the hell is the difference?
I have no idea.
Does an optometrist not able to do the glasses part of it? Are they actually specialized?
I don't know. Point is, I'm going to try and get him
an optometrist is like, you're fucked up. And then you go to the
So it's like an eye disease?
Here's how to fix it.
I don't think so.
Obviously, we don't know. Whatever. You need to go to somebody with glasses.
Yeah. I need to get an eye exam anyway because I need new contacts. I haven't had contacts for like 8 months.
It's such a painless and pretty quick process that is so hard to work into your life.
Yeah, I know. Just like getting your snip. It's the same thing.
It's true. Well, that
really
is.
At the same time.
If they could do
if there was a place that did both, I would go with Ryan and film it.
Why is it? Is there a male pill, like a birth control?
I think they did create a male pill, but
it's somebody's dick exploded, so they.
The female pill ain't that great either.
I don't think the male pill's
got bad
the
experiences.
I think they've developed one, but
it's
not
just like
available.
Hormonal imbalances and like just.
That shit ain't great.
It's not a good thing to do to your body for
ladies. Or woman's.
The woman's. So this $800 for your PC.
Yeah.
Why would you, if you both bring in an income, she got the vet money.
No, yeah, but that was
AH money.
Paid for by the Twitch.
Oh, yeah.
That's a whole other budget.
Ah. Well, so why is it a big deal?
Because you bring in income and it's a shared income.
Yeah, it's like, that's part of the house.
That's how it works. It's both of your money.
Yeah,
if
it's like, new capture card
if it's like, this income will help me make income, then it's like...
Well, yeah.
And that's why
she
said yes.
Fine with it. Yeah, there was no argument other than I get to cover it with cat stickers.
Hello, Key.
She has not yet purchased the stickers. There'll be an update when the stickering happens.
Nice.
Before
the stickering 2016.
On the upside, the heatsink I bought was too big for the case, so there's one whole wall just missing that she can't sticker.
There you go.
So a custom build?
Yeah. I blame the guy at
When I built
she get a smaller heatsink.
Well, I blame the guy at Fry's. I was like, I'm just going to get this water cooler right here. He's like, you know... With only the single fan solution for a water cooler, it's really not any more effective than this air cooler right here. How about you take this one? I'm like, are you sure? I'm going to buy this case right here. I don't think it'll fit. And he's like, it'll be fine. wasn't fine.
I mean, it sounds fine without, you know, the side of it.
He was wrong.
When I was
maybe
doing my PC,
that's what he was thinking.
I've built PCs in the past, but they've already been like sub built, and then you just add new stuff to them. This is the first one where it's like I'm putting a motherboard into an empty case one. So I just hooked it up and put it all together, and then turned it on to see if it worked. And it worked. It booted. It was great. And I was like, I could just leave it like this. I'm not going to cable manage
just
this in any way. I was just like, put it in. I just didn't do anything for cable management. But it's fine. I don't think that stuff really even matters that much.
It doesn't matter that much, especially if you're not doing any like overclocking.
Or yeah, something. It doesn't look good if you look inside. It's just like, but I did a thing where the desk that I bought didn't fit. It was like an L-shaped desk, and it was meant to connect to the main bit of the desk, but the two desks weren't compatible. So I basically got an L part of a desk that I don't have, so it just sits on the ground like this. But my PC is the exact correct height for me to balance the desk on. So my PC is wedged against
perfect.
The wall and is the leg
no, Ryan,
of my
no,
desk.
Perfect.
No,
fucking
yeah.
It's perfect.
No, that's
yeah.
not.
That's
and not
it good. Just sits on it, and it's like absolutely, I put
Ryan,
a,
would you use
I
the word
spirit level on it.
In that situation?
I put the level on it, it's perfectly in the middle. It's like, oh, this is great.
But does that case not have vents on the top?
Yes, it does, but it also has two big handles that go over that you can lift with. So the fans are like this much below the desk.
I mean, that's if they're exhaust
better than
fans,
nothing.
That's not awful. I mean, that's probably okay
and it's,
clearance.
And it works fine and never overheats. It's the best screw up I've ever had, really. It's the best of a worst situation.
Remember the beginning
why are
you of
this
annoying?
Podcast?
I'm
just, you
it's
annoy
always
me. You.
You
annoy me.
It's
look,
you.
You're gonna make the most
it's
of what
you.
Happens. It's like, oh, this
but what happens is because of you. You make the most of what happens because you fucked it up. That every time you make the most of when you smash everything on the fucking table and everything's destroyed and there's glass over the floor. Make the most of it, or just don't do it.
The thing I'm not looking forward to is I need to put another Ethernet card into the PC,
why?
which means your desk is fucked.
I can only download Phantom.
Anytime you move Ethernet, your computer, your
and
desk
I'm sick
is gonna
of switching
fall
between
over.
Internet and Phantom, so I have to probably take everything off the desk. But
you gotta
I know
it.
What I'm gonna do is
prop
I'm gonna
it.
Lift the desk up. Drag the PC out, put it down, everything's gonna slide to one end. I'm gonna be like,
Wedge something under there first,
yeah,
then pull the PC
just
out.
Buy a new PC.
No, that's insane. That's insane. Buy a new PC case.
Yeah, there you
yeah.
go. Wait,
and just
I'm gonna
drag
case.
It out and then open the side and then put the new Ethernet.
Do you have to have it directly patched to the computer or could you just put it through a switch?
I can, I've done that. It doesn't, I don't get the speeds for some reason. I got gigabit switch. Okay. But it's like, it chugs. Less than half speeds of that. Ooh. I don't know why that is.
Yeah.
Well, then, there you
go.
Could
just get a USB Ethernet connection.
Could I?
Yeah, you got USB Ethernet cards.
You okay, Jeremy?
Yeah, no, I'm just thinking
it
about all that.
You just let out like a disaster, like a...
It
a,
was,
a,
my brain was going about that. I gotta,
is.
I need to make a new
use
PC.
A size.
I gotta build a new PC.
Yeah, do what I just did.
It's just a
you
whole
don't listen
lot
to the guy
work.
About the heatsink.
Yeah.
And don't worry if you don't have a leg for your desk.
There you go. Yeah,
there you go. I was actually kind of, it was, you build a new computer and almost invariably the first time you hit the power button, it does nothing.
That's why I was so amazed when mine just booted immediately. I was like, I don't want to touch it. I don't want to do cable management.
Wait, I don't want to touch it again. And also I had the added thing of, when I went to Fry's to buy it and they were like, I asked for a 6700K processor and like, oh yeah, we got five of those. They're all smashed. Like the boxes were just all crushed and shit. And they're like, we'll still sell it to you. It might work.
Do you get a discount?
I asked. I was like, so you gonna knock some money off that? And he's like, I can take $10 off.
Oh, come on. $10 off of what? How much?
$300
fuck you.
Something dollars.
Yeah.
Dude, that's like 20% off.
It took
I
it down to $309.
Off.
Well, I mean, the box was just a little smashed. But it was smashed. Like, they don't make big boxes for those processors anymore because they don't put the heat sinks in them anymore. So it used to be like this whole clamshell thing, and now it's just like a tiny little plastic clamshell just around the processor, which is stuck to the front of the box, and it was completely knocked off the box and just rattling around in there. And I said, well, fuck it. Nothing else is open. It's a Sunday. Okay, I'll take it. If I have to come back, whatever. I was hoping
oh my God.
That I would hit the power button and nothing would happen, so I'd have a legitimate reason to go back to Fry's and be like, this doesn't work, and the thing's too big. But it turned on immediately and works great.
So now
like,
you just don't... You just have a side that's not on.
Yeah. Because once yeah. I wedged it in there, it's like it's now heat sinks attached from the back of the motherboard, and I have to take the whole motherboard out to take
so
the heat
is it
sink
that
off. And it's,
there's too much stuff in the way, or it literally won't close with it on?
The heatsink itself is fine, but it's got the copper tubes that run from the heat transfer tubes that run up through the fins have just little nubs right on the end, and the nubs are the only thing that stick out.
Foiled by nub.
I've thought about like clipping them off, or like.
Oh yeah, you should do that.
I might. It seems like it'd be real scratchy.
I feel like you haven't really built a PC unless you've done a little bit of a bodge job to get it to work. And that's what I did with my desk, just bodged it.
That's, yeah. You know what? I'm not 100% against you on this. Yeah. I think that was clever use.
I will absolutely, when I build my PC, paint the case too.
Yeah?
When I get it. Yeah.
Racing Strike.
Cat stickers, go for it.
That?
No, I might do like Borderlands-y, make it look cool.
Make
it like
you
yellow.
Make it a
little, I'm
it?
Sorry, are you going to make it Rimmy?
I could make it Rimmy!
I mean, when you say Borderlands, I think Rimmy. Isn't that where Rimmy started?
Rimmy Tim started in Borderlands.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're gonna streamline make... color.
I like how you, I like how I just completely just changed your world.
Yeah.
That's what I thought you were gonna say.
That's gonna be the
so I thought you meant by
Borderlands. Existence.
The
yeah.
Rimmiest.
Yeah. Deal.
Brandon just asked me for like the fifth time to if I wanted to be on his and Joel's show, and I'm gonna be out of town.
Bam.
It's just me laughing every single time he's asked me. I've
Is
been out
the
of town.
Is it next Tuesday one?
It's next Thursday.
Next Thursday.
I've been out of town or shooting something else. And I'm like, I'll do it. I will do it. I swear I'm not just saying no. I'm literally not here like five times in a row. He asks me every 3 weeks and I say like, ugh, I gotta do something else.
It was actually fun.
I know. That's what everybody says. It was a lot of fun. And I'm like, yeah, I'd love to do it. Has any of those come out yet?
I don't think so.
Because it's a show that Brandon and Joel are doing, and it's already, people are already talking about it, and they've made
live, I don't think they've announced audience. Like a name.
No, but they've made tweets about it and stuff, yeah. Because there's a live audience, and people have come to the shows. But it's after work, I'm not even going to get into like what kind of show it is, but it's what Joel and Brandon have been working on for the last several months. It's pretty different from like everything that Rooster Teeth does. It really has, it's not here. It has nothing to do with like the company here. And they have a lot of other guests on outside of Rooster Teeth. I think each episode they just have one person from Rooster Teeth on it. And then they have like other people
Unless
on the show.
Yeah. Joel. Yeah.
Right. Joel and Brandon. But as far as like the guests and stuff. But everybody who's watched it and everybody who's been there said it's been a lot of fun.
Because of so, that show, here's
this is like a late night show.
Here's my text history with Joel. Texted me August 19th. Saying, what do you know about the subject of social media etiquette? Then another text message. Think you would have things to say? My response was, I don't know much, man. What exactly would that be for? Never responded. Here's my, that's my text
I'm
history
shocked
with Joel. That's
texted
it.
You.
Well, that's, yeah. I mean, that's, you know, he had his time with
yeah.
Joel.
I am, yeah.
Be submerged in water, not
now
coffee.
You just need to submerge in water to get
yeah.
the coffee out.
Yeah, it's... Water generally not overflowing with sugar.
Why don't you maybe step it down a little bit and go into beer?
My conversation with Joel is a text from Joel saying, man, been breathing glue fumes all day. Not sure can see straight. Where are you getting bevved up at? And I said, Mena. It's from years ago.
Nice.
All right.
April 2014.
There you go. It's only 2.5 years.
Yeah.
Most of my interactions with Joel is him just like touching me. When I see him
like
in the halls.
Like just palming your face.
Yeah, he's like squishing my face, like doing this.
It's a great
this.
Moment
like,
in,
Hi, Joel.
In the gauntlet where you're just having an interview and his hand comes through the curtain and he's just like...
Yeah, he's big on that.
Yeah.
He's big on that. Joel and Bernie, I think the only people in the company and my life that refer to me as Mikey.
I can see by your face that you love that name.
I mean, I don't really care. Doesn't really bother me. It's just bizarre. Like, even Bernie will do it, like, in his... He's just being weird. He'll be like, Mikey, how you doing? You know what I mean? It's not like normal. He'll never be like, Mikey, I was talking to you about this. You know what I mean? It's just him when he's being weird. Joel, I don't know. I can't place it with him. I don't know what he thinks.
No one knows what Joel thinks.
Yeah, Joel doesn't know.
Yeah, he doesn't know what's going
he's
on there.
He's a fucking mystery.
He's locked in his own prison.
Inscrutable he is.
Look at that, man.
All right, Hey, I'm sorry about your glass.
Yeah. Hey, Gav, when's your Battlefield video coming out? Remember you shot that slow-mo guy we mentioned earlier during the Battlefield ad read? When's it coming out? Do you know?
Nope. Soon. I'm working on it right
are
now.
Are you excited? No, you're not. You're doing the podcast right now.
I mean, I'm transferring footage right now.
Okay.
Gotcha. I accidentally shot like 800 gigs of footage for it, so I'm transcoding.
Is it good?
Oh, I nailed the button, dude.
There it is.
Is there something really fast that gets really slow and it looks cool?
Bullet.
Sweet. Yeah. All right. So check out that when that comes out. Sponsored by Battlefield and Gavin Free. Bum, 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 bum. So does the bullet make that sound?
No.
If you listen to the bullet in slow-mo, it's like...
Is it like an Inception thing where it's just the theme song played slower and slower every time you go to level deeper?
It does make a shockwave through the air, which is cool.
Shockwaves are cool.
I think I've seen a clip of what you're talking about. You were showing it
yesterday. On my phone, yeah.
Yeah.
And you'll see it.
Shockwaves are cool. When you hit the glass with the hammer, the mirror with the hammer, the shockwave that came out of that.
Shockwaves are cool. Awesome. When you shattered my glass earlier and it hit the table.
I bet there was a shockwave. Shockwave
like exploded.
Apparently,
there was a shockwave across Michael's face.
It was like right here. Here is where I was wet. And
apparently, if I shot a 50 cal sniper rifle, you know, big old fat bullet, and it just went by your head, the shockwave that the bullet was dragging would be enough to like split your skin and crack bones and shoot you in the head without even hitting you, basically.
It's a giant bullet.
A very violent
it's just like
thing.
A lot of mass moving very fast to the point where it would probably kill you if I missed.
So if you were
very
next
close,
to your desk when Jeremy kicked it, your head might have exploded.
The shockwave from his foot would have been worse than that because his foot is bigger
than
50 cal.
The drag from his foot would have just exploded your head like one of these pumpkins.
It kind of honestly looks like a video game force field or a movie force field, but it's real life shockwave.
Compression wave.
Yeah.
Well, how about that?
Well, thanks for watching Off Topic, episode number 48.
48?
Yeah, we're almost at a year, dude. We're almost at a whole year of the big boy episodes. We are approaching, and just like Halloween, we'll do nothing to celebrate. I mean, I wore this because it was 6 seconds of effort. I had this in my dresser drawer this morning.
When
I went,
you said,
I'll wear that.
When you said we should all dress up for Off Topic,
you said that.
I forgot.
Yeah?
I might have said that.
You said it yesterday.
Oh, really?
I forgot.
I didn't.
And
I thought you said we should all punch a pumpkin.
Here's the thing about it, though. I knew you'd all forget. It doesn't bother me.
There he is.
Like, I already know what to expect. It's when things like everything exploding and shattering, which I didn't expect, that's when I'm thrown off a little bit.
Is my title related to what happened today?
No. I gave it to him before that.
Oh.
But we did discuss what your title is already.
Hmm.
I like working in the title to a conversation that I know is going to happen. Sometimes I'll steer it that way. But so I like giving them the Gavin title, knowing we will naturally have this conversation, and you'll have no idea that that's your title. That's my favorite title that I like to do. That or just viciously insult you.
Mm-hmm.
Like last week, you were missing but not missed.
Yeah.
Insult. Oh, fuck you. And this is why you're not
have
missed.
Have I been big nose idiot?
Because you fucking
idiot?
Broke everything. No, but that'll be the next one you're not here. I'll just do big nose idiot.
Okay.
All right. Thanks for watching. My phone's fucked up, Gavin. I'm going to take a whiz.
Bye.
I'm good.